doing a duet on the national anthem, Jerry. Starting lineups tonight, Bernie Wakely, and that's his 41st appearance for the Aeros, 23 wins, 13 losses, and 4 ties so far. John Chella and Paul Popiel back in the blue line as Ruskowski heads the forward unit at center, the Aeros captain, along with John Gray and Morris Lukowicz. At the other end of the ice, Mr. Smith, who has been tough against the Aeros this year. He's played 48 games for New England, 27 wins, 17 losses, and 3 ties. Brad Selwood and Rick Lee, the veterans, back on the blue line, with Davey Keon back in action for New England, along with Antonovich on the left side and Mayer on the right side. So let's go to center ice now. Jerry Trupiano and play-by-play.
Thank you, Jack Stanfield. Terry Ruskowski will face off against Dave Keon. And tonight's important hockey game is underway, and the Aeros get the draw, though Ruskowski now loses the puck to Antonovich. Here's Rick Lee on left wing in his own zone, starting out the center ice for New England. He's chased back by Aeros captain Terry Ruskowski. Lee on right wing to Brad Selwood in center ice. Ruskowski steps into him, knocked him down. Puck comes to John Gray, trying to clear it to center ice, and it's off the skate of linesman Ron Asselstein, trapped in that Houston zone, so they call it on a delayed offside.
Jerry, the Aeros have been able to win the last three games against New England, 6-4 and 5-4 here in the Summit. And then that last game on March the 3rd, that was a 3-2 overtime victory. Rich Preston getting that goal in overtime in New England.
Last two times into New England, Preston beat the Whalers in overtime. Here is Keon on the inboard, centering it in the Houston zone, and Shella broke it up. On left wing, John Gray leading pass to center ice for Ruskowski, taken away by Mayer. Jim Mayer runs into John Gray. Now Ruskowski has the puck for the Aeros, dropping it back in center ice on right wing to John Shella. Shella, left wing pass to Paul Popiel, and here come the Aeros again to Ruskowski, moving into the Whalers zone. Ruskowski checked from behind by Antonovich, who clears it out into center ice. Now to Dave Keon, moving into the Houston zone. Keon centers it. It comes to Jim Mayer on the inboards. He gave it away to Ruskowski. Ruskowski lost the puck, comes up with it again. And Terry Ruskowski passing over along the near boards for John Shella. Shella to center ice for the Aeros, across center ice red line. Long shot from center, knocked down by Smith, the goaltender, the first save of the game. He clears it around on the left wing boards in his own zone to Mike Antonovich as the Aeros start a line change. Here's Gordie Howe in center ice. In on right wing to McKenzie, he has a breakaway, and it's offside now at the Houston blue line as McKenzie had to take the high pass from Gordie Howe but preceded the puck in across the Houston line for the offside whistle.
Gordie Howe has been the leading and most effective New England player all season long against the Aeros. He has 4 goals and 7 assists. And Jerry, you were saying that in the third period in that game in New England, he took charge and really brought that New England club back to tie the game.
Gordie Howe, Mark Howe, and John McKenzie against the Aeros line of Larry Lund, John Tinelli, and Cam Connor. Here comes Tinelli for the Aeros in center ice. Moving in across that New England line, Tinelli still with that puck, looking to make a play. Here's Tinelli in the slot to Connor, a shutout, and he hit the goal post. Connor hit the goal post to the left of Smith. John Hughes from the point of drive. That misses on the short side, and back come the Whalers, clearing it to center. Al McLeod has it for the Aeros. Play is called, and now we're going to have John Tinelli ready to do some fencing here as the referee Bill Friday clamps down on things in a hurry. John Tinelli was a little upset, and he's going to the penalty box. I didn't see what happened. I was watching the puck. The action came back of the play. What happened, Jack?
Well, Tinelli coming back very quickly in front of McKenzie, and as we've mentioned on many broadcasts, McKenzie's the kind of guy that stirs it up out there, and he makes you mad before the game even starts, and John Tinelli playing left wing, he's going to be against him all night, wanted to establish the ground rules, and took McKenzie out rather briskly, I might say, and for that effort then picked up the 2-minute penalty. We'll see, I think, probably for elbowing on the call at 1:39. The Aeros and now go to the shorthanded situation.
New England has scored 44 power play goals. Rich Preston in center ice, checked on the play by Ron Plum. It comes loose for Gordie Howe to Dave Keon. Flips it in on an open wing in the Houston zone, Andre Lacroix. The Aeros leading scorer out as a penalty-killing forward, shoots it down the length of the ice. Whalers have Gordie and Mark Howe up front with McKenzie, Keon and Plum on the points. Here comes Mark Howe on right wing to Gordie Howe, breaking into the Houston zone, and Andre Lacroix stops it and clears it down the ice. Mark Howe in the neutral zone. Now to Dave Keon. Back to Mark Howe, who missed it inside the New England blue line, and the crowd gets on Mark Howe. Some strong feelings here as the Aeros fans won't forget the Howes or forgive them for leaving Houston. Now the puck cleared into the Houston zone, going back is Mark Howe to get it. Got it to Gordie Howe to Mark Howe, centering it. McKenzie in front, a shot, and he fired it wide. Rebound to Rich Preston. Preston fighting an opening, shoots it out into center ice with a minute five left in Tinelli's penalty. Ron Plum moving into the Houston zone, dumps it on the end boards, and John Hughes takes over for the Aeros, rolls it in front of his own goal. McLeod breaks it up, now to Lacroix, shooting at the center, and going back is Plum for New England. Now 50 seconds left in the Aeros penalty to John Tinelli. The Aeros with Lacroix, Preston, McLeod, and Hughes out there as the penalty-killing unit. The Aeros have had 58 power play goals scored against McKenzie, walking into the Houston zone. Goes in on the end boards against Al McLeod, who hammers him along the end boards. Now Keon at the left point for Mark Howe. The shot! Wakely makes the save, covers up on the puck as Wakely was screened on that shot from the point by Mark Howe. Wakely went down to his knees, stopped it, and then fell on top of the loose puck.
New England club making a change here, Jerry. But I think this is going to be a key factor, the penalty killing and, of course, the power play. Both clubs on the season with 44 power play goals going into this game. One thing you've got to keep your eye on are shorthanded goals. Rich Preston's got three on the season. Davey Keon for New England has picked up four, the only four New England have.
Here's a change for New England. They have Mike Rogers up front with Tim Sheehy and Gordie Roberts. Gordie Roberts, a defenseman, playing up front here on the New England power play. The Aeros clear at the center with 28 seconds to go in Tinelli's penalty. Here is Tim Sheehy for New England across center ice red line into the Houston zone. On left wing at the left point, now to Rick Lee. Right point for Selwood, a shot, and that's fired wide on the far side. Rebound to Lee, shooting, misses everything. Now Connor after the puck. It's taken away by Mike Rogers. Connor knocks him down. Loose puck comes back to the point. Ruskowski breaks it up but can't clear it. Now Ruskowski lost it to Gordie Roberts. Roberts closing in on goal. Now to Rogers, a shot, he scores! Mike Rogers from a sharp angle. Somehow he got loose. The Aeros went after Roberts, who got it to Rogers, who fired it in on the power play to give New England a 1-0 lead.
Number
after
17.
Rogers' 20th goal of the season, and on the power play, his fourth power play goal. But Rogers, who has been particularly effective this year against the Aeros, two goals and three assists going into this game. And crafty little centerman, really, but asking why Robert should be on that forward line, certainly we got our answer.
Rogers is 20th of the year from Gordie Roberts. And the Whalers lead 1-0. Here's a lead pass for Preston, breaking in against Jack Carlson in that New England zone. Preston on the end board, still with that puck in the near corner. Preston centers it in front. It's knocked away by Gordie Roberts. He's checked by Ron Hensis. Now Roberts finds an opening, shoots at the center ice, and Larry Hale goes back for the Aeros on right wing to Shella. Now to Andre Lacroix, moving in on right wing. Lacroix lets the shot go. Smith the kick save. Now the rebound comes out for Gordie Roberts, clearing it to Jack Carlson. He tried to shoot it out. He does to center ice, and Preston back to get it for the Aeros, who trail by one. Now to Shella. Shella to Lacroix, breaking into that Whaler zone. In for Preston, in a shot, save made. Going to be a penalty here to New England. Aeros get it to Lacroix. Play is called as the hand pass from Preston to Lacroix. Play is called. Going to be a penalty here against the New England Whalers at 4:21 of the first period. And big Jack Carlson heading for the penalty boxes. He pulled down Rich Preston, who was in the clear.
23, 2 minutes for hooking.
The Aeros get their opportunity to respond as they go to the power play, looking for their 45th goal of the season on the power play. That last goal was scored right on the number, 3:39. The penalty initially was at 1:39, Jerry, so the penalty at 3:39. Power play goal or not?
I say it would be, because the man wasn't back.
That's
on.
Right.
Now here is Preston on that Houston power play to Ruskowski, now to Andre Lacroix. The Aeros with the extra man. Give it away to Dave Keon, and he shoots it down the length of the ice. Let's set the Houston power play. Paul Popiel and Terry Ruskowski are the point men, with Andre Lacroix, Rich Preston, and Morris Lukowich up front. The Whalers have Dave Keon and Mark Howe as the penalty-killing forwards. Gordie Roberts and Alan Hangsleben on defense. Here's a pass in for Lukowich, breaking in across the New England line. He's tripped up. It's cleared to center by the Whalers, and going back is Preston. Aeros try to get onside. Preston moving into the Whaler zone. Drop pass for Lacroix, tipped away by Mark Howe into center ice. So the Aeros have to go back. Now here is Ruskowski for Houston. They have the extra man, trailing by a goal. Ruskowski walking into the Whaler zone, gave it away to Gordie Roberts, and he breaks away in center ice. Around Popiel, in on goal, a centering pass to Mark Howe. Off the target, Mark dumps it in on the inboards. Roberts bumped by Terry Ruskowski. Gordie Roberts with that puck, ridden off the puck by Ruskowski. They push and shove. As Ruskowski challenges Roberts, and now back come the Aeros. Lukowich down right wing. into the New England zone. Drop pass, Lacroix. In on goal, Lacroix shoots. Save made, rebound, Preston, a shot. Smith the save, rebound, a shot. Smith the save. Rebound goes to Keon now, as Lukowicz was slashed at by Smith, and the puck cleared down the ice by Keon. And back go the Aeros with 35 seconds left in that penalty to Jack Carlson. Puck taken by the Whalers on the end boards, tied up for a faceoff. Play is called as Cam Connor has something to say to Gordy Roberts, and they push and shove, and the linesmen get in there real quick, and Gordy Roberts says, what do you want me to do? Just let you walk in on goal?
I think he was referring to his tactics. What did he do? What did he do, Trooper?
Came down with a lumber across Connor's back. Connor had tried to walk into that New England zone. Got it by Selwood, and then I think, Roberts came up with an elbow and really caught Connor.
He turned his back sort of on him and caught him with that elbow. And Connor's going back to give some instructions. They're going to work a play off this faceoff. See if it works.
You're listening to Aeros Hockey on KTRH in Houston, the sports voice of the Southwest. I'm Jerry Trupiano, Jack Stanfield. Broadcast partner to my right here. Larry Lund will take the faceoff against Mike Rogers to the left of Al Smith. The Aeros leading 4-3. The Aeros would like to capitalize here with the man advantage. Now they get set for the faceoff in that New England zone. Flo and Connor were a little over anxious. Now they get ready for the draw. Flo over anxious again, Connor checking him. And Flo is saying, well, look, what's going on here? Face off to the left of Al Smith. On the draw, the Aeros get the face off. Larry Lund bumped by Rick Lee. Lee trying to clear it. The Aeros, Shella couldn't hold it in. Connor in center ice going back to get it. To Andre Lacroix, now to Cam Connor. Connor in his own zone. To John Tinelli. Moving back for the Aeros on the power play. Tinelli flips it in for Andre Lacroix across the line. At the right point for Shella. Shella closing in. Couldn't get a shot. Tried to center it. Connor deflects it just wide of the goal. Penalized player Marty Howe is back on, and the Whalers clear it to center. Here's Andre Lacroix trying to get it to Tinelli. Mike Rogers steals it, moving into the Houston zone. Rogers, a drive right on. Wakely the save, and he holds on from the summit. This is Houston Aeros hockey. Leading 4-3, have it in their own zone. Al McLeod on left wing, clearing it up for Morris Lukowicz, circling back inside his own blue line for Houston. Now Lukowicz starting out around Mike Rogers through center. Here's Lukowicz moving into that New England zone to Terry Ruskowski, left point. McLeod, a shot, he fired it wide. Rebound at the right point. John Hughes missed it. Now runs into Jack Carlson. Carlson got away from him. Down left wing against McLeod, in with Rogers. Carlson moving in, a shot. Quickly to save. Rebound Carlson trying to center it. Bumped by John Hughes. And here comes John Gray for the Aeros. Gray, long lead pass for Lukowicz in center ice. Now to Terry Ruskowski. Here's Ruskowski around Gordie Howe, in on left wing for Al McLeod. Gordie Howe takes it away, shoots it down the ice, and this is Gordie Howe's first shift in some time for the New England Whalers. Less than a minute to play here in the second period. Lukowicz, bumped by Jack Carlson. Here's Al McLeod with it for the Aeros, just clearing it to center ice. And Gordie Roberts goes back to get it. Inside his own line to Mark Howe on left wing. Now to Ron Plum, in center ice, clearing it into the Houston zone. The Aeros knock it down, McKenzie up with it, centers it. And Lukowicz broke it up with a nice play. Going to be a penalty here against the Aeros. Penalty against Morris Lukowicz for holding at the 19:26 mark as he pulled down Johnny McKenzie. And the Whalers are trailed by one, will now get the extra man.
For 34 seconds, and then an opportunity, perhaps if they do not score, to kick off that third period of action. The Aeros just have settled back a little bit since they took over that 4-2 lead, Jerry. And you can't sit back on a club that can score like this, or a club that are in such an important game. I think you've got to take it to them. And I think when the Aeros have been skating, they've been dominating the game. When they haven't been skating, the Whalers have been pecking away at them.
Here's Larry Lund now to take the faceoff for the Aeros against Dave Keon. This is a big draw. 34 seconds remaining here in the second period. The Aeros leading 4-3 with a faceoff to the right of Ernie Wakely. Lund against Keon, and from the faceoff, the Aeros get it to Shella. Around on the near boards to Rich Preston. He tried to clear it, he does down the ice. And the goaltender Smith comes out to set it up for Mark Howe with 23 seconds remaining in the second period. Mark Howe leading the power play rush for New England. Moving into the Houston zone, a pass for Gordie Howe, too far ahead. Gordie in trying to center it. Larry Hale breaks it up at the right point. Plum holding it in. A shot blocked by Hale. Rebound comes to Preston. And Preston for the Aeros starting out to center ice on left wing to Andre Lacroix. Tips it down into the Whaler zone. Going back is Mark Howe, and that's going to do it for the remainder of the second period. And the buzzer sounds to end the period. New England will have the man advantage for the first minute and 26 seconds of the third period. The Aeros skate off with a one-goal lead at the end of two periods. Our score, the Houston Aeros 4, the New England Whalers 3. Back with a scoring recap very shortly from the summit. This is Houston Aeros hockey. We have a minute 5 left in that penalty to Morris Lukowicz. Face off to the right of Ernie Wakely. Lund loses this draw. Mark Howe at the left point. Now to Gordie Howe. Looking to make a play. Left point for Mark Howe. Taken away by Larry Lund. He fails to clear it. It's held in by the Whalers. Here's McKenzie to Gordie Howe. Referee Bill Friday had fallen, and the Aeros clear it down the ice now. Larry Lund doing some hard work there. Here comes Mark Howe for New England on the power play rush. Moving through center. Long slap shot wide of the goal. Rebound. Preston comes up with it for the Aeros, trying to clear it. He and Mark Howe tie it up along the near boards and hold it. Play is whistled down. 40 seconds left in that minor penalty to Morris Lukowicz. The Whalers have scored 45 power play goals, including one here tonight. Aeros have had 59 scored against.
Larry Lund coming out to take that draw. And the thing about it, Mark Howe with that good shot back on that blue line, even when he comes close to that blue line, he can fire it hard enough to beat you. And when you set up kind of a screen set up at the blue line, it makes it tough on the goalie.
Terry Ruskowski in his own zone for the Aeros. Takes a check by Mike Rogers. Now trying to get away from Gordie Howe. Flips it up for Larry Lund. Lund clears it out for Terry Ruskowski. The Aeros a man short. Ruskowski moving in one on two. Stops to get away from the first man. Now Ruskowski trying to walk around Mark Howe. And Mark Howe knocked it over to Jamie McKenzie. Now on right wing to Ron Plum. 18 seconds left in the Aeros penalty. Plum a long drive. That's wide of the target. Here's McKenzie in after the puck. It's taken away by Shella. Shella tried to clear it. Rogers holding it in. Lost it now to Shella, who runs into his own man, Paul Popiel, but clears it down the ice. And that will about do it for the remainder of that penalty to Morris Lukowicz. As Plum goes back, Lukowicz steps on. The Aeros kill off the penalty. Here come the Whalers. Rogers on left wing, shooting it down to the Houston zone. Going back to get it, John Tinelli. Tinelli for the Aeros. Big Tonto Tinelli winding up in his own zone. Tinelli around Gordie Howe. Moving into the Whalers zone. Pull down on the play. Gordie Howe is going to get a penalty here. Gordie Howe will get a penalty here for hooking as he pulled down John Tinelli at the 1:44 mark of the third period.
Well, one thing you have to admire is the art of the whole thing, the way Gordie took Tinelli down there with the move of the left stick, and I think probably the first time Gordie ever got, well, I wouldn't say that, a standing ovation for a penalty. He's getting a little bit of ribbing there as he sits in that penalty box.
I saw Gordy's wife Colleen here tonight.
A big game, really, this one, and Colleen down to get a first-hand look.
Face off to the left of Al Smith. The Aeros on the power play. They could use a goal here. From the draw, Lacroix at the right point holding in. Let's the shot go, deflected over the top of the goal by Tinelli. Rebound, Lund at the left point for John Hughes. In now for Lund. It's taken away by the Whalers, and they clear it down the ice, and the Aeros have to go back. The Aeros have John Hughes and Andre Lacroix as the point men. Lund, Tinelli, and Connor up front. Whalers have Keon with Antonovich, Lee, and Selwood. Here's a pass to John Hughes, breaking in on left wing across that New England line. The goaltender plays it away. Hughes in the corner, got it to John Tinelli. Left point to Andre Lacroix. Now to Tinelli, to John Hughes. Hughes for the Aeros, trying to make a play. Left point to Andre Lacroix, trying to get it through to Hughes again. Here's Hughes for the Aeros, now to Tinelli, in a shot! Smith the save, rebound. Hughes to Larry Lund. He looks for the open man. To John Hughes in the far corner. Hughes for the Aeros, now to Larry Lund. He searches for an open man. Now to John Tinelli. Tinelli to Connor at the right point, winding up a shot! Smith the save, rebound, Tinelli missed it. Larry Lund and Rick Lee doing some fencing. Now the puck cleared down the ice and the Aeros have to go back. Here is Wakely setting it up for Andre Lacroix. Now Lacroix for the Aeros, moving out of his own zone to center ice with Ruskowski, Tinelli, and Connor. Lacroix into that New England zone, around one man. Goes in deep against Gordy Roberts. Tinelli, a shot, that's wide. Now Plo tried to clear it. Got it by Connor to center ice, and the Aeros have to hustle back and get onside. Here's Ruskowski, missing a check by Steve Carlson. Terry Ruskowski, still with that puck, walking into the Whalers zone. The Whalers clear it away. Aeros go back with time for one more rush. Here's Popiel. 25 seconds left in the penalty. Left wing pass to Terry Ruskowski. He's checked on the play. Now it comes back to Paul Popiel, and here come the Aeros. Head manning that puck to Andre Lacroix, moving in against Gordy Roberts. Now the Aeros get it to Lukowicz. Lukowicz is checked off the puck, and here comes Gordy Roberts for New England, starting back with 10 seconds left in Gordie Howe's penalty. Gordy Roberts into the Houston zone, in on goal. Checked away by the Aeros Popiel. Now a shot by Larry Plo is stopped by Wakely, and here come the Aeros again. Preston as Gordy Howe steps back on. Now in Preston to Andre Lacroix, looking to center it, a score! Andre Lacroix was deflected. We'll have to wait and see who gets the goal. But Lacroix's centering attempt was deflected. And the Aeros increased their lead to 5-3. I think Lacroix got the goal.
It may have hit
New England player, a New England player in the stick and deflected in.
Preston to Lacroix and a backhand move trying to get that puck to Preston. It looked like it may have gone off of someone in front of the net there, and that's a big break for the Aeros as they open up that two-goal lead now. 16:08 remaining, but number seven, Andre Lacroix, getting on the scoreboard here tonight as he gets a goal along with the assist he had earlier. So continuing to just play unbelievable hockey, really. Lacroix is... he's not a pointer game man. He gets them in bunches and seems to get them with pretty good regularity.
Lacroix's 29th of the year has given the Aeros a 5-3 lead as the Whalers clear it into the Houston zone. Shell on left wing to Larry Hale. Out in center ice to Larry Lund. Lead pass for Connor on right wing. Moving in against Marty Howe. Connor takes Marty Howe to the end boards. They jam up and hold the puck. And now here's McKenzie pushing at Tinelli. Connor comes over and says something to McKenzie, and the linesman jump in there to get between Connor and McKenzie. Now Lacroix is going to come over. I think he may change the scoring on that goal. We'll wait and see.
They're still buzzing back and forth. Johnny McKenzie, he's not all that big, but a well-built hockey player, Jerry. He's always had good skating ability, but he's a sneaky hockey player, and he's always sort of bugging you from behind or from the side or grabbing you. You could just tell by the way the players react to him that they do not enjoy playing against him.
You'd love to have him on your team, though, wouldn't you?
No.
Oh, Marty Howe was running at Larry Lund and corked Lund over the top of the head with a stick, it looked like. And here come the Whalers. Oh, Connor stepped into Marty Howe. Here's a two-line pass offside at the center ice red line. A little head-hunting going on right now.
You know, I hadn't mentioned this, but Morris Lukowicz with a new style of skate on there tonight. Flying on the...
They'll all be out after them tomorrow, won't they?
They'll be looking for the sort of a new blade that's become pretty popular in the league and a new kind of boot. We'll talk about that.
Aeros get the draw to Shell on left wing to Larry Hale, clearing it up ahead for Larry Lund in that New England zone. He's knocked down by Marty and Gordy Howe. It was offside anyway at that New England blue line. And from the summit, this is Houston Aeros hockey. You're listening to Aeros Hockey on KTRH in Houston. The Aeros leading 5-3. The Whalers clear it down near corner in the Houston zone. Cam Connor goes back to take it away from Mark Howe. Here's Connor to John Shella. Shella for the Aeros. Watched by Mark Howe. Here's a right wing pass to Connor. Connor clears it up for Larry Lund. It's tipped away by Marty Howe. Now Lund with it. Just shoots it to center ice, and Connor takes over for the Aeros. Now to Larry Hale. Hale to Larry Lund. Down right wing, moving into the New England zone. Lund goes in against the Howe brothers. Mark Howe clears it to Ron Plum, now to Johnny McKenzie. Got it to Gordy Howe, on right wing and center ice. Lead pass for Mark Howe. He's tied up by Connor, who's going to get a penalty. Mark Howe took a dive, and they're going to give a penalty here to Cam Connor for hooking, and Cam can't believe it.
Mark Howe was breaking into the hole, and I think probably a good play on Mark's part. He had Connor with his stick out in front of him, and he knew he wasn't going to get through there, so he figured, well, we'll give it a little try, and down he went, and into the penalty box Mr. Connor goes. Connor knew right away that the way the play developed, he might be getting a penalty, and he sort of waved it off without even looking back, saying, hey, I don't think I deserved one there.
There's a change on the Aeros scoring play in the third period here. Lacroix from Preston and Wakely at 3:52. The Aeros lead at 5-3. Now New England goes to the power play at, where are we at here, 5:23. Wheelers on the power play trailing by two. Here's Al McLeod for the Aeros in his own zone. A pass for Rich Preston. It rolls to the blue line, held in by Selwood. Selwood dumps it in on the inboards in the Houston zone. Mike Rogers clears it back to the right point. Nobody home for New England. And the Whalers have to go back in their own zone after it. Here is Rick Lee on right wing now. To Mike Rogers, moving through center ice across the center ice red line. In on left wing, Rogers shoots it in on the inboards in the Houston zone. John Hughes back to play it to Terry Ruskowski. He let it roll down the ice, and the Whalers have to go back. Whalers have Rogers, Roberts, and Sheehy up front with Lee and Selwood on the points. Now the Whalers clear it into the Houston zone. Preston goes back trying to clear it. Hits Gordy Roberts with that puck. Now they tie it up in the corner. John Hughes pinning Roberts. It comes loose for Rick Lee. Lee in the corner for Roberts. He missed it on the inboards. McLeod takes Rogers out of the play. Now Ruskowski knocks Rogers flying. Here's Al McLeod for the Aeros. Bumped on the play by Gordy Roberts. Preston has it now to Terry Ruskowski. Here's Ruskowski one-on-one against Rick Lee, stopping in center ice. Flips it in for Rich Preston, racing in against Selwood. Now Preston comes up with that puck in the far corner. They jam up along the boards and hold it for the faceoff with 51 seconds remaining in the minor penalty to Cam Connor.
Here are the Aeros on the penalty killing situation, are number two in the World Hockey Association percentage-wise. Coming into the game, they had 58 goals scored against them in 288 attempts. And you have to keep in mind the number of penalties that the Aeros take. One of the most penalized teams in the World Hockey Association.
Here is Lacroix with Tinelli.
Who would be number one penalized team in the world?
Birmingham Bulls. Aeros playing their 66th game of the season tonight. Where is the season gone? Here's McLeod tying it up in that New England zone for a faceoff, and play is called as now Tinelli and McKenzie have something to say to one another.
I'll tell you, when the season goes quickly, it's usually because the team's playing well, Jerry, and the team has sort of slowly picked up momentum all season long and really starting to hit a stride, and I think still hasn't reached its full potential.
Here's Tinelli fighting McKenzie for the puck. The Aeros get it to Lacroix, who just dumps it out into center ice to take off more time of the penalty. Aeros shorthanded with Connor in the box, and now the Aeros clear it down the length of the ice. Going back is Mark Howe. Moving up to his own blue line and center ice for New England. Mark Howe moving into the Houston zone on right wing to McKenzie. A drive. Save made by Wakely. He covers up on top of the puck, and play is called. McKenzie shooting from a sharp angle. Really tested Ernie Wakely.
And sometimes if you can get enough steam on the puck, Mark Howe dumping that puck just off to McKenzie as he came across the blue line. McKenzie had a lot of speed, and that helped the weight of that puck as it hit the pads of Wakely. And if you hit just right in the crease, sometimes if you get enough speed on it, it'll work its way through.
Face off to the left of Wakely here with 21 seconds left in Connor's penalty. From the draw, the Aeros get it to McLeod. He ties it up with Antonovich along the boards, and play is whistled down. They will face it off again in the circle to the left of 37-year-old Ernie Wakely, who has come up with another strong game in that Houston goal tonight.
See in the background some of the boys from Inwood Forest Country Club out in my neighborhood.
They're looking for you. Broke one of their windows.
The golf course where
from
Aeros are members.
From the faceoff of the right point, Plum in that Houston zone. Left point for Mark Howe. It's intercepted by Andre Lacroix. Here come the Aeros. They're a man short. Lacroix in center ice. Drops it now and then took a hit by Gordy Howe. And Gordy Howe winds up in a heap on the ice. Here's Tinelli breaking in across the line. Moves it back to center ice as Cam Connor steps back on. McLeod lead pass for Connor. In on right wing against Mark Howe. Connor in that New England zone. Stops to make a play. Centers it through for Tinelli. He runs into McKenzie. And here comes Plum. Plum has it poked away by Tinelli, but Gordy Howe carries on. Moving through center, Gordy Howe fakes a shot, moving in towards the Houston line, rolls back now as he had a teammate offside. Here's Gordie Howe in center ice, stopped by Tinelli, still with that puck, shooting it into the Houston zone. Wakely comes out to catch the puck about an inch off the ice and holds on for a faceoff.
I had a kick out of that one play Lacroix made just a few minutes ago. He's killing off the penalty, and he was just outside of that New England blue line. He had about four New England players converging on him. He waited to the last second. He put the puck between his legs and backed out of the play, and they almost all converged on each other. That was the old sandwich play, but there wasn't anything spread in the middle.
Here is Larry Hale. The Aeros leading 5-3 up on left wing for John Tinelli. Checked by Steve Carlson at the right point. It's held in by Brad Selwood. Dumps it in on the end boards in the Houston zone. And here's Cam Connor. Around on left wing for Tinelli. Couldn't reach it. Going back for the Whalers is Selwood as it rolls back into his own zone. Selwood standing back of his own goal with the puck. His team down by two goals. Now to Gordie Roberts in the near corner. Roberts, a rink-wide pass on the right wing to Steve Carlson, moving through center ice. Now in on left wing for Danny Bolduc, in on goal, and it was offside anyway as Bolduc shoots it into the net after the whistle. And from the summit, this is Houston Aeros hockey. It will be family night Sunday night when the Aeros return home to take on the Indianapolis Racers here at the summit. Here comes Larry Lund on left wing to Paul Pulpeil, moving into the New England zone. A shot off the stick of Selwood up over the glass into the crowd as Selwood bumps with Pulpeil along the far boards. And play is called. A minute 11 left here in the first half of the third period. Aeros leading 5-3.
Jerry, later this month, the Aeros are going to be playing two international games, one against the Finnish national team. That'll be on the 19th, Sunday the 19th. And then on the 21st, and that is a schedule change, originally scheduled for the 15th of March, the Swedish national team will be in on the 21st. So that'll be the Sunday and Tuesday evening. Tickets available, of course, at all seven Foley's and the Summit box office.
Face-off coming up in that New England zone. You can also put the tickets on the Visa and MasterCard cards. Call 627-0916. That's 627-0916 to put your Aeros tickets on MasterCharge or Visa.
I think a good idea.
Here's the puck taken by Marty Howe for the Whalers. Clearing it to center ice. John Hughes comes up with it for the Aeros. Now trying to get it to Ron Hanses. It's knocked away by the Whalers. And Rogers has it in center ice. Across the red line, shoots it into the Houston zone. It goes skittering off the end boards. And it comes to Marty Howe at the left point. A shot deflected by Rogers wide of the goal. And here comes Rich Preston for the Aeros. Less than a minute to play in the first half of the third period. The Aeros move in on right wing to Hanses in that New England zone, and it's called on the offside as Hanses was a hair offside on the right wing.
Andre Lacroix clapping his stick down on the ice there, thinking that he should have just made that pass a little bit quicker as Ron Hanses moving in on that right wing in anticipation of the pass. Lacroix likes to hold the puck until the defenseman comes to him. So that he completely takes him out of the play, Jerry, and that's why a lot of times he'll give his wingers clear-cut breakaways.
Al McLeod for the Aeros in the center ice zone to Rich Preston. Now to Andre Lacroix. Here's Lacroix circling with that puck. Got around Mike Rogers down right wing. Lacroix chased back by Marty Howe. Lacroix still with it for the Aeros. On right wing to Ron Hanses. Hanses got it now to John Hughes, clearing it into the Whalers zone off the end boards. Coming back to get it, Rick Lee. 20 seconds left in the first half of the third period. Left wing pass to Marty Howe. Down that left wing and center ice across the red line, moving into the Houston zone. Lost it to Hanses, it was offside anyway, with Larry Plow in ahead of the play on left wing. We have 10:15 left in regulation time. The Aeros in front, 5-3.
Smith, you know, has shut the Aeros out a couple of times this season. Both times have been here in Houston. He's the second leading goaltender in the league in the goals against department. Only Gary Bromley is ahead of him. And he leads the league in games played with 48.
Aeros losing that puck in center ice, cleared back in by the Whalers. John Hughes goes back for the Aeros. Jack Carlson after him. They clear it on left wing for Rich Preston. 3 seconds to go until the buzzer here. Now Hanses in center ice, lost it to Marty Howe at the buzzer. The first half of the third period ends with the Aeros leading 5-3.
Jerry, Teddy Taylor skating a little bit better there, and he should be back into action. You heard Scott Campbell at the first period break there, and he feels that he'll be ready for action on Sunday. So you like to get everybody healthy again, along with the three goaltenders, Zimmerman and Rutledge and Wakely. I think the Aeros are heading down the stretch in pretty good shape. They get Terebinski back, gives him a little more depth on that blue line, a little more mobility also, because he's not all that big, Terebinski, but he can handle the puck well, and he can give you some more versatility on your hockey club.
All right, Bill Friday, the referee, ready to drop it between Terry Ruskowski and Dave Keon for the final 10 minutes of regulation time. The Aeros in front, 5-3. Here's Ruskowski on the draw against Keon, and from the faceoff it comes to Mike Antonovich in his own zone on right wing to Brad Selwood. Selwood, a left wing pass to Gordy Roberts. Roberts through center ice, flips it down into the Houston zone, knocked down by Paul Popiel, who clears it to center ice. Keon takes over, shoots it right back into the Houston zone. Here's Lukowich on the end boards for the Aeros. A left wing pass to John Gray. Gray for Houston, down left wing in center ice with Ruskowski. Here's a pass to Lukowich on right wing, moving in around Mike Antonovich. Lukowich looking for the hat trick, in on the end boards, bumped by Gordy Roberts. Now here's Popiel holding it in to Lukowich. He tries to make a play. Lukowich fighting for that puck. It's taken now by Selwood, as Selwood and Lukowich do some fencing. It's cleared to center ice. Now Selwood checked by John Gray, and Selwood steps into him. Now Ruskowski nails Mayer with a hard check along the boards. It's cleared to center, shot back in with Ruskowski trapped in there, offside at the New England blue line. And from the summit, this is Houston Aeros hockey.
Two minutes for interference.
New England Whalers penalty. While we were away, Jim Mayer of the New England Whalers takes an interference penalty at 10:54 of this third period. And the Aeros, who lead 5-3, go to the power play.
John Gray drawing that penalty. And the thing about Gray is he has good anticipation, can break into those holes, and a lot of times he'll catch the winger that's checking him off balance, and I think that's what probably happened. Mayer panicked, grabbed a hold of him because he knew he was beaten on the inside.
Lukowich over at the Aeros bench to get a new hockey stick.
Morris Lukowich, one of two hockey players on this Aero squad who have had hat tricks this season already. He has two goals here tonight, looking for his third. The other gentleman who has also had a couple of hat tricks over the season, John Gray, out there on the left wing.
Faceoff to the right of Smith, that comes to Popiel at the left point along the near boards for John Gray. He missed it. Selwood and Gray go to the corner. It comes to Gordy Roberts. He tried to clear it out. Andre Lacroix missed it. Terry Ruskowski holding it in. Now Mike Antonovich steals it. Shoots it down the ice on goal. Ernie Wakely makes the save. Clears it on left wing to Paul Popiel, cutting back of his own goal. A minute 40 left in the New England penalty. Popiel headmans the puck to Andre Lacroix down left wing in center ice. Lacroix in on left wing to John Gray, moving in against Selwood, deep, looking to center to hit the side of the goal. Now going in, Lacroix against Dave Keon, it's tied up. Now Lukowich goes to the corner, takes a run at Gordy Roberts, some pushing and shoving down in that corner, and the linesmen get in there very quickly to separate Lukowich from Gordy Roberts. We haven't seen Rick Lee in a while for New England.
I tell you, you better watch that puck when it comes around the boards the next time. I think Lukowich moved that board that he hit back about 6 inches. He actually missed Roberts. Roberts was only insulted. He wasn't hurt. 7,995, 8,000 here tonight, Jerry. We were hoping to get it over the 10,000 mark, but
on the faceoff, the Aeros get the draw to Gray on the near boards, and then New England zone centers it. Here's Lukowich, a shot, and he fired it wide, going for the hat trick.
You get the feel he's sort of skating around. Josh is with the puck.
Zone. Hughes bumped in the play by Gordy Roberts. Here comes Andre Lacroix. Moving into the Whaler zone. Now to Hanses. Hanses at the left point for Paul Popiel. Losing it to Marty Howe, who takes a run at McLeod. The Whalers throwing their weight around here. Now up with it. Rogers in the near corner to Ron Plum. Plum starting out for New England. Clears the puck to center ice. John Hughes dumps it back in for the Aeros. Going back is Marty Howe to get it. And he shoots it down the ice. Icing the puck. Going back for the Aeros, Al McLeod to touch it. And New England is called for icing. What do you do that for?
Looked like a bit of a frustrated play, really. Marty may be a little bit ticked off at something that happened earlier in the shift. And he went into a little bit of a fog as he went into the corner.
League President Howard Baldwin is here.
President of the New England Whalers and league president. We discussed that over the regular season.
Andre LaCroix.
What does that mean?
I don't know.
Can you do that?
Obviously. Whalers starting back. Rogers on right wing to Tim Sheehy. Sheehy, long shot from center over the top of the goal. Rebound to Marty Howe. Fans on the shot. It comes loose for the Aeros. Ron Hensis playing it up on right wing for Andre LaCroix. Trying to clear it. He does off the stick of Marty Howe to center ice. Here's a pass in on right wing to Sheehy. Into the Houston zone. Shooting far and wide. Now the puck comes to Gordy Roberts in deep. He tried to center it. Comes back to the right point for Ron Plum, a shot nowhere near the target. The rebound comes now for Hensis, and here come the Aeros. Hensis into Andre LaCroix, into that New England zone. LaCroix bumps with Rick Lee. Here's Tim Sheehy on the near boards for Ron Plum. And Plum for the Whalers clears it to center ice. Shella takes over for Houston. Now to Hensis, the pass was behind him. It rolls down into the New England zone. Back to touch it, Rick Lee. And the Aeros are called for icing. The crowd oohing and aahing here as Lee, as he touched the puck, almost put it into his own goal. It wouldn't have counted if play was stopped once Lee touched the puck.
You get the feeling there's a little head hunting going on out there. Everybody's sort of skating around. It's not wide open right now. Everybody's being very, very cautious with the puck. And one-on-one situations, men are making sure they get their man. They're playing the Canadian Mountie game. Everybody gets their man.
Elsewhere tonight in the WHA, Quebec is at Birmingham. Edmonton plays at Cincinnati. Winnipeg home against Indianapolis. They have a crowd of about 7,000 on hand for tonight's game. Maybe a little better than that. Face off to the left of Wakely. 2-2 game here in the second period. Whalers get the draw. Now Lukowich breaks it up and clears it to center ice. Brad Selwood takes over, a left wing pass to Rick Lee. He shoots it down into the Houston zone. Wakely sets it up for Larry Hale. Lost it now to Jim Mayer, who's bumped by John Chella. Larry Hale takes the puck away on right wing to Morris Lukowich. Long lead pass in center ice for John Gray. Knocked away by Selwood, who gave it away to Gray, clearing it into the New England zone. Here's Selwood now around on left wing for Rick Lee. Up on the boards for Antonovich starting out. Got it by Shella. Antonovich checked in center ice by Terry Ruskowski. He passes the puck ahead for Gray. It's taken away by Selwood. Shoots it into the Houston zone, and Morris Lukowich goes back for the Aeros. Lukowich leaves it on the end boards for John Shella. Chased around his goal by Dave Keon. Here's Shella with that puck. On the right wing in his own zone to Captain Terry Ruskowski. Lead pass in center ice for Gray. Lead now to Lukowich. Has a breakaway. In on goal. Lukowich shoots. He scores! What a goal by Lukowich! And the Aeros take the lead for the first time tonight at 3-2.
Now that's as pretty a passing play as you'll want to see anywhere. They relayed that puck, and that puck moved from the Aeros zone up the ice as quickly as possible. Shella, who made the initial pass coming out of his own zone, the puck was relayed then on a beautiful pass across to John Gray at center ice, relayed to Lukowich. He went in and he beat the goaltender with a fake behind him, and he put it in. A beautiful passing play by the Aeros.
Lukowich, his 34th goal of the season, and the Aeros lead it 3-2. Now Ron Plum clears it into the Houston zone. Going in after it, Mark Howe tried to center it. Here's McKenzie with the puck to Mark Howe in the slot. Checked by Larry Lund. Back come the Aeros. Lund whacked on the iron by Gordy Howe. Here's Lund still with that puck. Fires it down into the New England zone. Connor going in after Ron Plum knocks Plum off the puck. Now McKenzie tried to clear it. The Aeros holding it in. Marty Howe on the far boards. Connor after him tried to shoot it out. Larry Lund holding it in. It's cleared to center. And going back is John Hughes for the Aeros. Plays it off the boards. He's knocked down by McKenzie, and Hughes has been shaken up. Now play is called as Hughes took a check from McKenzie, and he's down on the ice.
That was
Hughes with that
pretty
right
cheap
leg.
Shot, really. That's a
getting
cheap
up slowly.
Shot. That is a cheap shot.
Caught him,
caught him from the blind side, and he gave him a knee. More of a Charlie horse is what he'll probably end up with in that upper leg muscle, but a blind sider, and I'll tell you, that's a cheap shot. In any way you can describe it as far as I'm concerned.
John Hughes is hurting, and he's still staying out there for the Aeros. And
better to skate it out if you can.
And Jerry. Hughes is staying out there. Now the Aeros are called for icing as the Whalers go back and get it in their own zone. And from the summit, this is Houston Aeros hockey. Here's John Tonelli for the Aeros, moving in against McKenzie. They bring the sticks up. Now play goes on as the Whalers clear it down the ice. Johnny McKenzie, as they used to say in the old neighborhood, is cruising for a bruising here. The Aeros now go back to touch at the Whalers and call for icing.
The old neighborhood? Well, where did you live? That's in St. Louis now. What street? What was the name of the gang?
5673 Hiller Place. I didn't belong to the gang. The gang was the Walnut Park.
5673 Hiller Place gang. Is that it?
Used to be the Walnut Park ACs, but I never belonged to them. Those were the tough guys. I was a nice school
the
going
Walnut
kid.
Walnut Park ACs?
Yeah, they were tough.
What did the AC stand for?
I'd hate to tell you. They invented acupuncture. Acupuncture and Charlie Horse.
Accurate cutting?
Not bad. Here are the Aeros in their own zone, leading 3-2, clearing it out for Ron Hanses. Now to Andre Lacroix, moving into the New England zone. A shot blocked at the defense by Hangsleben. Lacroix got the rebound, tried to center it. Knocked away by Larry Plow. Here's a battle for it in the corner. The Aeros steal it. Now Hangsleben breaks it up, shoots it to center ice for Mike Rogers. It hopped over his stick, rolls in on goal. Wakely the save. He sets it up for Larry Hale, chased around the goal by Rogers. Out in center ice, here come the Aeros. Andre Lacroix to Rich Preston. Right wing pass for Hanses, moving into the Whaler zone. Hanses going in against Gordy Roberts, tied up by Roberts. Hangsleben moving in after the puck. Play is called, and there's going to be a holding penalty here against New England. Gordy Roberts will be given the gate here for holding Ron Hanses. A good effort by Hanses along the fire boards, and he draws the penalty from Gordy Roberts. Whatever. A power play goal look good here.
I'll tell you, Hatz is driving on that right side, and that's the difference, Jerry. He didn't just give up when he was taken out of the play. He tried to get by, he worked hard, and with the referee right on top of the play, Bill Friday was able to call that holding call on Roberts. That's at 6:38 here. The Aeros have taken the lead 3-2. Now let's see if they can widen that margin with a power play goal. They have not scored on the power play here tonight. See if they can notch their 45th power play goal of the season.
Lacroix, Preston, and Lukowicz up front. Popiel and Ryskowski on the points. At the right point, Terry Ryskowski along the far boards for Morris Lukowicz. In the corner to Andre Lacroix, centering it in front. The goaltender breaks it up. Whalers try to clear it. Ryskowski holds it in at the right point. Here's Ryskowski against Keon. They fight for the puck. Ryskowski now to Lukowicz off his stick. Here's Andre Lacroix for the Aeros, looking for that open man. Lacroix in the slot for Preston. The shot deflected wide by Mark Howe. Rebound comes to Lukowicz on the near side. Selwood has lost his stick. Now here's Andre Lacroix with it for the Aeros. In the slot, a shot by Lukowicz. Save, rebound. Lukowicz shoots it wide. Now the rebound comes to Lukowicz again for the Aeros. At the right point to Terry Ryskowski. Ryskowski still with that puck. In now for Andre Lacroix. Lacroix centers it. A shot. They score. Lukowicz. Lukowicz got into the open, and somehow Andre Lacroix got it to him. And the Aeros up their lead to 4-2 in the
number seven
era. Andre Lacroix is amazing, in a word.
I don't know how he finds him. He's like a fine quarterback. That play from the left point into Lacroix, good control, and right across the crease, and it got on Lukowicz's stick, who was in the net so fast that, you know, it's really hard to believe that you can release the puck that quickly. Lukowicz, who is the leading goal scorer, picking up a second here tonight in the game at his 35th goal of the season on the power play. Boy, oh boy, they've taken charge of this hockey game. 4-2 now.
Give a lot of credit to Terry Ryskowski, too, the Aeros captain, who made a great play at the point to hold it in.
Everybody, but you know, one thing, Lukowicz was really buzzing around. He was very alert on that power play, getting the loose puck a couple of times, but jumping into the open spots.
I think somebody may have hit referee Bill Friday from the seats. The officials are glaring down in the corner. some of the Aeros fans. Now here's Lacroix in his own zone for the Aeros. Lead pass for Preston off his stick and rolls down into the New England zone. Preston going in against Plum. Preston checks Plum, but Marty Howe goes back to touch the puck, and the Aeros are called for icing.
Preston a little bit upset because that puck came out of the corner at a funny angle, and he had a chance to touch it. Would have made that play onside.
Scratch from the Aeros lineup tonight, Ted Taylor, Scott Campbell, Paul Terbenchi, and Wayne Rutledge. For New England, George Lyle, Tom Webster, and Andre Palafi out of the lineup this evening. The big loss for the Whalers, of course, Webster. He's out for the year with a back injury. And people ask me what's wrong with the New England Whalers, and you may trace their downfall to the back problems of Tom Webster. Faceoff to the left of Ernie Wakely, Lacroix against Rogers. They get everybody lined up, and the Aeros get the draw. Here's Rich Preston. He tries to clear it in center ice, lost it to Jack Carlson. Moving into the Houston zone, Carlson around one man, goes in against John Hughes. Hughes breaks it up, trying to get it to Lacroix. Comes to Larry Plow. Plow trying to make a play, still with that puck. Has it stolen now by Al McLeod on right wing to Ron Hansis. And Hansis out of Brownsville, Texas, shoots it to center ice for Andre Lacroix. Now a pass in for McLeod in that New England zone to Lacroix. In a shot, Smith the save, rebound. Here's Preston in against Ron Plum. They battle for it along the boards. Preston digs it loose. He's knocked flying by Jack Carlson, head first into the boards. And Preston has been shaken up here. He's down in the corner in a heap, and they're going to bring Aeros trainer Bobby Brown out as Carlson caught Preston with a hard check along the boards, and now Preston is getting up, and he appears to be okay, bending over as he skates along the near boards in the New England zone. Carlson was the first one there to make sure that Preston was okay, and he goes back to talk to Rich Preston. Jack Carlson used to be, well, the real tough guy, and now we've got a problem down here with some of the fans. I think the officials are being bugged by some of the fans, but Carlson has turned into a hockey player. Before, he was just there for his muscle, but he is playing hockey, and he went over to make sure that Preston was okay.
Well, the tough thing about that check, Jerry, it happened far enough away from the boards that Rich was knocked off balance, and so he had momentum going into the boards as he was losing his balance, and then the boards, as he had gained in or maintained or gathered a little momentum, catching him, and that's an awfully hard hit.
Now the Whalers have it in their own zone. 4-2 lead for the Aeros as New England shoots at the center ice. Here's a pass in on right wing for Cam Connor. Connor checked by Marty Howe, knocks the puck away. Now in center ice, Connor steps into Larry Plow, almost pushes him up into the Aeros bench, and now Marty Howe took a run at Larry Lund, and Connor got him in a bear hug right away, and play is called.
Connor hitting everything that moves out there, and if he continues to hit that way, Jerry, he's going to get that extra room when he goes in the corners, because the big youngster is one of the most respected players in the league, and the style of hockey he's playing right now is to his advantage.
Here's Ruskowski, Gray, and Lukowicz out against Keon, Antonovich, and Bolduc for New England. Aeros leading 4-2 as Shella clears it into the Whalers zone. Going back is Alan Hangsleben. Hangsleben shoots it around, up off the stick and into the crowd. Faceoff will be outside of the New England blue line because of the deflection by Ruskowski into the crowd. It hit Ruskowski's stick, so the faceoff will be moved outside of the New England zone.
So Lacroix picks up another point and helps him move a little bit in that scoring race in the WHA. Andre Lacroix is number 6. With 85 points, that one point would move him one ahead of Robbie Fatorik.
Here's Ruskowski on the draw against Keon outside of the New England line, and the Whalers get the draw. Ruskowski checking Keon. John Gray takes it away for the Aeros, flips it in on the end board. Smith comes out to set it up for Hangsleben. Hangsleben tried to clear it. Shella holding it in, a shot wide on the far side. Here's Danny Bolduc with the rebound. Clears it ahead in center ice for Dave Keon. Lost it to Paul Popiel, now to Lukowicz. Back to Shella. Here's Shella down right wing for the Aeros. Into the New England zone. Shella going in deep, trying to take a shot. He does. Smith holds on and gets a faceoff in that Whaler zone, and Shella took an extra little run at Cordy Roberts as they collided along the end board.
I tell you, I like the way that John Shella's playing lately, and he's skating well. He's leading the odd rush, but yet he's playing good sound defensive hockey. And he's had some injury problems somewhat this year, Jerry, and I think just starting to round into good shape.
Ruskowski on the draw against Keon to the left of Smith, and the Whalers get the draw. Here's Gordy Roberts shooting at the center from Mike Antonovich. In on right wing to Danny Bolduc, breaking into the Houston zone. Bolduc in on goal, stopped by Gray. Rebound of the puck comes to John Shella. Dumps it in front of his own goal. Wakely plays it on right wing for Lukowicz. and the Aeros control it in their own zone. Here's Popiel down the left wing. Pass in for Lukovic. Too high and too hard to handle. Dave Keon clears at the center ice. Mike Antonovich bumped by Paul Popiel. They whack at one another with their hockey sticks and play goes on. Aeros dump it back into the Whalers zone. Here's Hangsleben to Antonovich. Shooing it out into center ice now for Keon. He did just shoot it right out there.
He shoot it.
Well, whatever.
He got it out of there.
Now Lukovic checking Keon. The puck rolls to center ice and going back to get it. Hangsleben. 9:52 left here in the second period. Aeros leading by 2 goals. Now the Whalers move it into the Houston zone. Danny Bolduc along the near boards. Got it to Mike Antonovich, a shot knocked away by Wakely. Rebound comes to Connor and he just golfs it out to center ice. And going back is Hangsleben for New England. Alan Hangsleben with Connor after him. Connor checks him, steals the puck, in on goal. Connor shoots. Smoot the save, it may have hit the goal post. I think Connor hit the goal post again, and is he hot? Great rush by Connor, pulled Smith down and up, and then hit the goal post.
Well, it's got to go in for him sometime here tonight. He has done everything. And that one was a spectacular effort as he just stole the puck off the New England player at the blue line with a good anticipation move by Connor. And then he walked in all alone and went to the backhand, had the goaltender beat, but as you said, Jerry, looked like he hit the post.
Connor stole it from Hangsleben, walked right in, and apparently did hit the post. Here's Selwood now to McKenzie in his own zone, losing it to Larry Lund in front for John Tinelli. He's checked by Rick Lee. Crowd wanted the penalty, and Bill Friday says no. Here's Gordie Howe to McKenzie, moving into the Houston zone, in deep. McKenzie centers it in front, loose puck. Wakely covers up on it with Gordie Howe right there trying to bat it in. From the summit, this is Houston Aeros hockey. Gordie Howe at the right point for Brad Selwood. Shooting blocked by the Aeros' Kim Connor. Now John Hughes tried to clear it. Held in by Selwood at the right point. Left point for Rick Lee. Connor goes out, tries to block it. The shot goes wide. Now John Hughes for the Aeros. Shoots it around on the near board. Selwood at the right point holding it in. Now to Gordie Howe at the right point for Selwood. Fakes a shot, closing in. Selwood in a drive, fired wide on the far side. Lee at the left point holding it in. Right point now to Selwood. Dumps it into the end boards now for McKenzie, trying to center it. The Aeros break it up. Here's Hughes in the corner against Gordie Howe. It comes to the left point for Lee. A shot blocked by Larry Hale. Now loose in front. McKenzie trying to take a shot. Fans on it. John Hughes for the Aeros after the puck. Connor doesn't have a stick. Hughes clears it to the blue line and out. Rick Lee brings it back in. It's Cowell on the offside finally at the Houston blue line.
Bill Friday making that call, actually, as it was... linesman had been forced outside of the zone because the play was coming right at him. So Bill was a little bit closer to make that call. Gordie Howe leads the Whalers with points this season, Jerry. Although Gordie really, I don't think, has had a lot of ice time here tonight. At least it seems that way.
Faceoff will be outside of the Houston blue line. It comes to Paul Popiel, now to Rich Preston. Preston shooting the puck through center ice. Mike Rogers back to get it. Now to Ron Plum. Plum standing at his own line on right wing to Jack Carlson. Bumps with Paul Popiel as he clears it into the Houston zone. Going back is Shella. A right wing pass for Hensis. Hensis clears it to center ice, and here comes Andre Lacroix. Moving into the Whalers zone. Drop pass Popiel. In front for Lacroix. The Popiel a shot. Smith the save. Rebound. Lacroix shooting right through the goal mound. Now Popiel for the Aeros. Trying to move around Jack Carlson. They battle for the puck. It's cleared to center ice, and here come the Whalers. Rogers down right wing with Plow. Rogers moving in against Shella. Shooting, they score! Mike Rogers gets his second of the night, cutting the Aeros' lead to 4-3.
Good effort by Rogers on that one as he made everybody back 17. Up and then kind of put the brakes on and then cut into the center zone. And as he did, fired not a hard shot, Jerry, but a quick shot on that wrist shot as he picks up his second goal of the evening. Mike Rogers doubling his total on the season against the Aeros in the goal-scoring department.
That's his second of the night, his 21st of the year. And Rogers, who was the third leading scorer on the Whalers behind Forty and Mark Howe, has come up big. He hasn't gotten that much ice time this season. Now Preston in center ice for the Aeros, knocked down by Jack Carlson. Here's John Chella for the Aeros. Moving into the Whalers zone, now to Hansis in front for Preston, and hopped over his stick. Now here's Jack Carlson. Moving back on right wing against Chella. Carlson to the blue line, down left wing, a pass on right wing for Mike Rogers. In for Jack Carlson into the Houston zone. Carlson in against Chella. Chella knocked him down. Now they go to the corner. Here's Andre Lacroix for the Aeros, stopping to get away from Larry Plow. Aeros leading 4-3. Lacroix to Chella. Watched by Jack Carlson, bumped by Carlson, clears it to center ice for Preston. Now a pass for Lacroix is intercepted by Larry Plow, moving in on right wing. Into the Houston zone, Plow going in deep, stops, falls. Puck is picked up by the Aeros, and here's Popiel out in center ice, clearing it away. Now the Whalers shoot it back in. It's picked up by Shella, called on a delayed offside. And from the summit, this is Houston Aeros hockey. Rick Lee after the loose puck in his own zone for the Whalers, twisting and turning away from Gray, got it now to Hangsleben. Alan Hangsleben on left wing, now to Steve Carlson, clearing it into the Houston zone, going back is Al McLeod, taken to the corner boards by Sheehy. They jam up and freeze it, and play is called.
Jerry, the Aeros go on the road on Saturday night. We will be in Indianapolis, back-to-back games, in fact, playing Indianapolis in Indy, and coming back here on Sunday at 6 o'clock. That'll be another family evening. Bring the family out, of course. The special ticket prices, $5.50 section for $3. Two or more members of the family, and see Aeros against Indianapolis Sunday at 6.
Here is Steve Carlson after Al McLeod, who got the puck to Morris Lukowich on left wing, down to Larry Hale. And Hale comes to center ice for the Aeros. Now a pass to McLeod down that left wing, in against Selwood. Going in deep now against Rick Lee. Lee on the end boards in his own zone. Checked by McLeod. McLeod almost steals that puck. Here's Selwood with it on the near side, starting back on right wing. Selwood to center ice. The Aeros leading 4-3. Selwood clears it to the far corner in the Houston zone. Going back, Captain Terry Ruskowski, a left wing pass for Gray. He tried to clear it out. He does to center ice, and here's Lee for New England. 5:40 left here in the second period. The Aeros leading 4-3. Sheehy on left wing to Lee, clearing it into the Houston zone. Wakely on the end boards, leaves it for Larry Hale. Tried to get it to Gray. It's stolen by Tim Sheehy. Sheehy looking to make a play back of that Aeros goal. Still with the puck. Watched by Larry Hale. Gave it away now to Terry Ruskowski. Ruskowski checked by Hangsleben. Hangsleben taking it away. Ruskowski ties Hangsleben up. They push and shove. Ruskowski lays the lumber on Hangsleben. And here's John Gray to Al McLeod. He tried to shoot it out. Selwood at the right point, holding it in. A drive wide. Rebound comes to Lukowich. He clears it on right wing to Terry Ruskowski. And back come the Aeros. Through center ice, Ruskowski. Into that New England zone, tripped up by Lee. Play goes right on. The Aeros changing defense. Here's a pass for Steve Carlson. Into the Houston zone on right wing. Leaves it now for Selwood, bumped by Paul Popiel. Carlson dumps it in front. Lukowich bumps with Hangsleben as Wakely holds on for a faceoff, and play is called.
Well, New England sort of taking the play to the Aeros here. They're behind by one. The Aeros leading 4-3. 4:53. The Aeros kind of biding their time a little bit, looking for that break that can give them another two-goal pad, but you can't wait too long, Jerry. You've got to take it and take some pressure off your goaltender, get it down at the other end of the ice, and show them that you're going to still be in control of this hockey game.
Aeros sending out the line of Lacroix, Preston, and Hansis against the Keon Antonovich Bolduc line for the New England Whalers. Faceoff will be to the left of Ernie Wakely. I think Gordie Howe's line is missing a shift here. From the draw, here's Lacroix getting it into his own zone to Paul Popiel. In the corner for John Chella, slapping it back of his own goal. On left wing for Preston, trying to move out. Plum checks Preston in center ice. Plum and Preston battle for it, and it's held in center ice for a faceoff. Play is called with 4:38 remaining here in period number two. The Aeros leading 4-3.
Well, it's a game that's been marred a little bit here in the last bit with a few whistles as the checking is getting a little bit tighter.
Marty Howe in center ice on right wing to Ron Plum. Plum flips it into the Houston zone. Popiel missed it. Going back is Shella against Keon. Shella takes it away. A right wing pass to Ron Hentzes, and the Aeros start out. Hentzes lost it to Marty Howe. Now to Dave Keon. In on left wing to Antonovich. Shooting! Quickly got a glove on it to steer it wide. Now Keon bumps in the corner with Paul Popiel. Here's Lacroix with the puck. On right wing for Ron Hentzes. Lost it to Bolduc at the left point. Marty Howe a shot off the skate of Shella wide of the goal. And here comes Preston for the Aeros. Rich Preston through center ice, still with that puck. Moving into the New England zone on right wing, going in deep, looking around. Marty Howe centers it in front. They break it up. Shella at the right point, holding it in, but play had been called, and the Whalers are going to get a penalty here. Marty Howe is going to get a penalty here. And as soon as the Whalers gain possession, referee Bill Friday called the play, and Marty Howe goes off for tripping at the 16-minute mark of the second period.
Well, so the Aeros get a golden chance here, Jerry, to spread that lead a little bit more. We talk about a little bit of hot streaks for the Aeros lately. Andre Lacroix with 7 goals and 9 assists in the last 11 games. John Gray with 8 goals and 3 assists. And John Tinelli, 1 goal and 9 assists. So Tinelli's really been moving that biscuit around, picking up a lot of assists for some hard work. Last power play goal, and the only power play goal by the Aeros here tonight by Morris Lukowich.
Lacroix, Preston, and Lukowich up front with Popiel and Ryskowski playing the points. Aeros get the draw, left point. Popiel a shot, Smith the save. It almost got by him, but he deflected it by the goal, and now the Whalers clear it to center ice, and the Aeros, Popiel has it now to Rich Preston, firing it back into the New England zone. Smith missed it back of the net. Here's Lukowich in the corner to Andre Lacroix. Lacroix in front for Lukowich, a shot wide, rebound. Lukowich with that puck. He looks for the open man. Aeros with the pressure on, left point Paul Popiel. Now to Andre Lacroix. Lacroix trying to make a play. To Rich Preston in the near corner. Now to Andre Lacroix for the Aeros. At the left point, Paul Popiel fakes a shot. Now into Lacroix, into Lukowich. Couldn't get a shot at the right point. Ryskowski, a drive! Smith got an arm on it to knock it wide. Lee and Preston pushing and shoving. Here's Lacroix. Stopping. Left point, Paul Popiel holding it in. Paul Popiel for the Aeros. Over for Preston. It's knocked away by Gordy Roberts. And Lee clears it out into center ice for Mark Howe. Moving in against Paul Popiel. In on goal. Mark, a shot. Quickly the save. He covers up on the puck. Mark Howe using that strength of his. Asking for a penalty now from referee Bill Friday as he thought Popiel held him up.
Popiel doing a fine job taking Mark Howe out there. A good clean check as he used that effort with his shoulder, really, to just kind of push Mark Howe enough off balance that he couldn't get that shot away. Good defensive play by Paul Popiel. Bill Dineen giving him a little bit of a rest after that hard effort.
A minute left in the penalty to Marty Howe. 3 minutes left here in the second period. The Aeros on top by the score of 4-3, but they can use a little insurance. Larry Lund on the faceoff against Steve Carlson to the left of Ernie Wakely. The Aeros get the draw. Here's Larry Lund. Now to Andre Lacroix. Up on left wing for Larry Lund. The Aeros starting out to Lacroix. Lacroix on left wing to John Tinelli, moving through center. Right wing pass for Cam Connor, moving into the Whalers zone. Connor trying to make a play at the right point for Shella. It's knocked away by Larry Plo, who clears it to center ice. Coming in, Steve Carlson in against Andre Lacroix, who breaks it up. And here's Shella clearing it out for Connor. Connor for the Aeros inside his own line. Cam Connor with that puck. Down left wing for the Aeros. Moving in across that New England line. Runs into Gordy Roberts. Now, puck taken by the Whalers on the end boards. Tied up for a faceoff. Play is called as Cam Connor has something to say to Gordy Roberts. And they push and shove. And the linesmen get in there real quick. And Gordy Roberts says, what do you want me to do? Just let you walk in on goal?
I think he was referring to his tactics. What did he do? What did he do, Cooper?
Came down with a lumber across Connor's back. Connor had tried to walk into that New England zone. Connor tried to sell wood, and then I think, Roberts came up with an elbow and really caught Connor.
He turned his back sort of on him and caught him with that elbow. And Connor's going back to give some instructions. They're going to work a play off this face-off. See if it works.
You're listening to Aeros Hockey on KTRH in Houston, the sports voice of the Southwest. I'm Jerry Trupiano, Jack Stanfield. Broadcast partner to my right here. Larry Lund will take the faceoff against Mike Rogers to the left of Al Smith. The Aeros leading 4-3. The Aeros would like to capitalize here with the man advantage. Now they get set for the faceoff in that New England zone. Flo and Connor were a little over anxious. Now they get ready for the draw. Flo over anxious again. Connor checking him. And Flo is saying, well, look, what's going on here? Face off to the left of Al Smith. On the draw, the Aeros get the face off. Larry Lund bumped by Rick Lee. Lee trying to clear it. The Aeros, Shella couldn't hold it in. Connor in center ice going back to get it. To Andre Lacroix, now to Cam Connor. Connor in his own zone. To John Tinelli. Moving back for the Aeros on the power play. Tinelli flips it in for Andre Lacroix across the line. At the right point for Shella. Shella closing in. Couldn't get a shot. Tried to center it. Connor deflects it just wide of the goal. Penalized player Marty Howe is back on, and the Whalers clear it to center. Here's Andre Lacroix trying to get it to Tinelli. Mike Rogers steals it. Moving into the Houston zone. Rogers a drive right on. Wakely the save, and he holds on from the summit. This is Houston Aeros hockey. Leading 4-3, have it in their own zone. Al McLeod on left wing, clearing it up for Morris Lukowicz, circling back inside his own blue line for Houston. Now Lukowicz starting out around Mike Rogers through center. Here's Lukowicz moving into that New England zone to Terry Ruskowski, left point. McLeod, a shot, he fired it wide. Rebound at the right point. John Hughes missed it. Now runs into Jack Carlson. Carlson got away from him. Down left wing against McLeod. In with Rogers. Carlson moving in, a shot. Quickly to save. Rebound Carlson trying to center it. Bumped by John Hughes. And here comes John Gray for the Aeros. Gray, long lead pass for Lukowicz in center ice. Now to Terry Ruskowski. Here's Ruskowski around Gordie Howe. In on left wing for Al McLeod. Gordie Howe takes it away, shoots it down the ice. And this is Gordie Howe's first shift in some time for the New England Whalers. Less than a minute to play here in the second period. Lukowicz, bumped by Jack Carlson. Here's Al McLeod with it for the Aeros, just clearing it to center ice. And Gordie Roberts goes back to get it. Inside his own line to Mark Howe on left wing. Now to Ron Plum, in center ice, clearing it into the Houston zone. The Aeros knock it down. McKenzie up with it, centers it. And Lukowicz broke it up with a nice play. Going to be a penalty here against the Aeros. Penalty against Morris Lukowicz for holding at the 19:26 mark as he pulled down Johnny McKenzie. And the Whalers are trailed by one, will now get the extra man.
For 34 seconds, and then an opportunity, perhaps if they do not score, to kick off that third period of action. The Aeros just have settled back a little bit since they took over that 4-2 lead, Jerry. And you can't sit back on a club that can score like this, or a club that are in such an important game. I think you've got to take it to them. And I think when the Aeros have been skating, they've been dominating the game. When they haven't been skating, the Whalers have been pecking away at them.
Here's Larry Lund out to take the faceoff for the Aeros against Dave Keon. This is a big draw. 34 seconds remaining here in the second period. The Aeros leading 4-3 with a faceoff to the right of Ernie Wakely. Lund against Keon. And from the faceoff, the Aeros get it to Shella. Around on the near boards to Rich Preston. He tried to clear it. He does down the ice. And the goaltender Smith comes out to set it up for Mark Howe with 23 seconds remaining in the second period. Mark Howe leading the power play rush for New England. Moving into the Houston zone. A pass for Gordie Howe too far ahead. Gordie in trying to center it. Larry Hale breaks it up at the right point. Plum holding it in. A shot blocked by Hale. Rebound comes to Preston. And Preston for the Aeros starting out to center ice on left wing to Andre Lacroix. Tips it down into the Whaler zone. Going back is Mark Howe. And that's going to do it for the remainder of the second period. And the buzzer sounds to end the period. New England will have the man advantage for the first minute and 26 seconds of the third period. The Aeros skate off with a one-goal lead at the end of two periods. Our score, the Houston Aeros 4, the New England Whalers 3. Back with a scoring recap very shortly from the summit. This is Houston Aeros hockey. We have a minute 5 left in that penalty to Morris Lukowicz. Face off to the right of Ernie Wakely. Lund loses this draw. Mark Howe at the left point. Now to Gordie Howe. looking to make a play. Left point for Mark Howe, taken away by Larry Lund. He fails to clear it. It's held in by the Whalers. Here's McKenzie to Gordie Howe. Referee Bill Friday had fallen, and the Aeros clear it down the ice now. Larry Lund doing some hard work there. Here comes Mark Howe for New England on the power play rush. Moving through center. Long slap shot wide of the goal. Rebound. Preston comes up with it for the Aeros, trying to clear it. He and Mark Howe tie it up along the near boards and hold it. Play is whistled down. 40 seconds left in that minor penalty to Morris Lukowicz. The Whalers have scored 45 power play goals, including one here tonight. Aeros have had 59 scored against.
Larry Lund coming out to take that draw. And the thing about it, Mark Howe with that good shot back on that blue line, even when he comes close to that blue line, he can fire it hard enough to beat you. And when you set up kind of a screen setup at the blue line, it makes it tough on the goalie.
Terry Ruskowski in his own zone for the Aeros. Takes a check by Mike Rogers. Now trying to get away from Gordie Howe. Flips it up for Larry Lund. Lund clears it out for Terry Ruskowski. The Aeros a man short. Ruskowski moving in one on two. Stops to get away from the first man. Now Ruskowski trying to walk around Mark Howe. And Mark Howe knocked it over to Johnny McKenzie. Now on right wing to Ron Plum. 18 seconds left in the Aeros penalty. Plum a long drive. That's wide of the target. Here's McKenzie in after the puck. It's taken away by Shella. Shella tried to clear it. Rogers holding it in. Lost it now to Shella, who runs into his own man, Paul Popiel, but clears it down the ice. And that will about do it for the remainder of that penalty to Morris Lukowicz. As Plum goes back, Lukowicz steps on. The Aeros kill off the penalty. Here come the Whalers. Rogers on left wing, shooting it down to the Houston zone. Going back to get it, John Tinelli. Tinelli for the Aeros. Big Tonto Tinelli winding up in his own zone. Tinelli around Gordie Howe. Moving into the Whalers zone. Pull down on the play. Gordie Howe is going to get a penalty here. Gordie Howe will get a penalty here for hooking as he pulled down John Tinelli at the 1:44 mark of the third period.
The one thing you have to admire is the art of the whole thing, the way Gordie took Tinelli down there with the move of the left stick, and I think probably the first time Gordie ever got, well, I wouldn't say that, a standing ovation for a penalty. Getting a little bit of ribbing there as he sits in that penalty box.
Saw Gordy's wife Colleen here tonight.
A big game really this one, and Colleen down to get a first-hand look.
Face off to the left of Al Smith. The Aeros on the power play. They could use a goal here. From the draw, Lacroix at the right point holding in. Let's the shot go, deflected over the top of the goal by Tinelli. Rebound, Lund at the left point for John Hughes. In now for Lund. It's taken away by the Whalers, and they clear it down the ice, and the Aeros have to go back. The Aeros have John Hughes and Andre Lacroix as the point men. Lund, Tinelli, and Connor up front. Whalers have Keon with Antonovich, Lee, and Selwood. Here's a pass to John Hughes, breaking in on left wing across that New England line. The goaltender plays it away. Hughes in the corner, got it to John Tinelli. Left point to Andre Lacroix. Now to Tinelli, to John Hughes. Hughes for the Aeros trying to make a play. Left point to Andre Lacroix, trying to get it through to Hughes again. Here's Hughes for the Aeros, now to Tinelli, in a shot, Smith the save, rebound. Hughes to Larry Lund, he looks for the open man, to John Hughes in the far corner. Hughes for the Aeros, now to Larry Lund, he searches for an open man. Now to John Tinelli, Tinelli to Connor at the right point, winding up a shot, Smith the save, rebound, Tinelli missed it. Larry Lund and Rick Lee doing some fencing. Now the puck cleared down the ice and the Aeros have to go back. Here is Wakely setting it up for Andre Lacroix. Now Lacroix for the Aeros, moving out of his own zone to center ice with Ruskowski, Tinelli, and Connor. Lacroix into that New England zone, around one man. Goes in deep against Gordie Roberts. Tinelli a shot, that's wide. Now Plo tried to clear it. Got it by Connor to center ice, and the Aeros have to hustle back and get onside. Here's Ruskowski, missing a check by Steve Carlson. Terry Ruskowski, still with that puck, walking into the Whalers zone. The Whalers clear it away. Aeros go back with time for one more rush. Here's Popiel. 25 seconds left in the penalty. Left wing pass to Terry Ruskowski. He's checked on the play. Now it comes back to Paul Popiel, and here come the Aeros. Head manning that puck to Andre Lacroix, moving in against Gordie Roberts. Now the Aeros get it to Lukowicz. Lukowicz has checked off the puck, and here comes Gordie Roberts for New England, starting back with 10 seconds left in Gordie Howe's penalty. Gordie Roberts into the Houston zone, in on goal. Checked away by the Aeros Popiel. Now a shot by Larry Plo is stopped by Wakely, and here come the Aeros again. Preston as Gordie Howe steps back on. Now in Preston to Andre Lacroix, looking to center it, a score! Andre Lacroix was deflected. We'll have to wait and see who gets the goal. But Lacroix's centering attempt was deflected. And the Aeros increased their lead to 5-3. I think Lacroix got the goal.
It number may have seven, hit
New England player, a New England player in the stick and deflected in.
Preston to Laquan, a backhand move, trying to get that puck to Preston. It looked like it may have gone off of someone in front of the net there, and that's a big break for the Aeros as they open up that two-goal lead now. 16:08 remaining, but number seven, Andre Lacroix, getting on the scoreboard here tonight as he gets a goal along with the assist he had earlier. So continuing to just play unbelievable hockey, really. Lacroix is, he's not a pointer game man. He gets them in bunches and seems to get them with pretty good regularity.
Lacroix is 29th of the year, has given the Aeros a 5-3 lead as the Whalers clear it into the Houston zone. Shell on left wing to Larry Hale. Out in center ice to Larry Lund. Lead pass for Connor on right wing. Moving in against Marty Howe. Connor takes Marty Howe to the end boards. They jam up and hold the puck. And now here's McKenzie pushing at Tonelli. Connor comes over and says something to McKenzie. And the linesman jump in there to get between Connor and McKenzie. Now Lacroix is going to come over. I think he may change the scoring on that goal. We'll wait and see.
They're still buzzing back and forth. Johnny McKenzie, he's not all that big, but a well-built hockey player, Jerry. He's always had good skating ability, but he's a sneaky hockey player, and he's always sort of bugging you from behind or from the side or grabbing you. Or you could just tell by the way the players react to him that they do not enjoy playing against him.
You'd love to have him on your team, though, wouldn't you? No. Oh, Marty Howe was running at Larry Lund and corked Lund over the top of the head with a stick, it looked like. And here come the Whalers. Oh, Connor stepped into Marty Howe. Here's a two-line pass offside at the center ice red line. A little head hunting going on right now.
You know, I hadn't mentioned this, but Morris Lukowicz with a new style of skate on there tonight, flying on the...
They'll all be out after them tomorrow, won't they?
They'll be looking for the sort of a new blade that's become pretty popular in the league and a new kind of boot. We'll talk about that.
Aeros get the draw to Shell on left wing to Larry Hale, clearing it up ahead for Larry Lund in that New England zone. He's knocked down by Marty and Gordy Howe, who was offside anyway at that New England blue line. And from the summit, this is Houston Aeros hockey.
The second assist goes to number 31, Ernie Wrigley. Wrigley is good.
You're listening to Aeros Hockey on KTRH in Houston. The Aeros leading 5-3. The Whalers clear it down near corner in the Houston zone. Cam Connor goes back to take it away from Mark Howe. Here's Connor to John Shella. Shella for the Aeros. Watched by Mark Howe. Here's a right wing pass to Connor. Connor clears it up for Larry Lund. It's tipped away by Marty Howe. Now Lund with it, just shoots it to center ice, and Connor takes over for the Aeros. Now to Larry Hale. Hale to Larry Lund, down right wing, moving into the New England zone. Lund goes in against the Howe brothers. Mark Howe clears it to Ron Plum, now to Johnny McKenzie. Got it to Gordy Howe. On right wing and center ice, lead pass for Mark Howe. He's tied up by Connor, who's going to get a penalty. Mark Howe took a dive, and they're going to give a penalty here to Cam Connor for hooking, and Cam can't believe it.
Mark Howe was breaking into the hole, and I think probably a good play on Mark's part. He had Connor with his stick out in front of him, and he knew he wasn't going to get through there, so he figured, well, we'll give it a little try, and down he went, and into the penalty box Mr. Connor goes. Connor knew right away that the way the play developed, he might be getting a penalty, and he sort of waved it off without even looking back, saying, hey, I don't think I deserved one there.
There's a change on the Aeros scoring play in the third period here. Lacroix from Preston and Wakely at 3:52. The Aeros lead at 5-3. Now New England goes to the power play at, where are we at here, 5:23. Wheelers on the power play trailing by two. Here's Al McLeod for the Aeros in his own zone. A pass for Rich Preston. It rolls to the blue line, held in by Selwood. Selwood dumps it in on the end boards in the Houston zone. Mike Rogers clears it back to the right point. Nobody home for New England. And the Whalers have to go back in their own zone after it. Here is Rick Lee on right wing now. To Mike Rogers, moving through center ice across the center ice red line. In on left wing, Rogers shoots it in on the end boards in the Houston zone. John Hughes back to play it to Terry Ruskowski. He let it roll down the ice, and the Whalers have to go back. Whalers have Rogers, Roberts, and Sheehy up front with Lee and Selwood on the points. Now the Whalers clear it into the Houston zone. Preston goes back trying to clear it. Hits Gordy Roberts with that puck. Now they tie it up in the corner. John Hughes pinning Roberts. It comes loose for Rick Lee. Lee in the corner for Roberts. He missed it on the end boards. McLeod takes Rogers out of the play. Now Ruskowski knocks Rogers flying. Here's Al McLeod for the Aeros. Bumped on the play by Gordy Roberts. Preston has it now to Terry Ruskowski. Here's Ruskowski one-on-one against Rick Lee, stopping in center ice. Flips it in for Rich Preston, racing in against Selwood. Now Preston comes up with that puck in the far corner. They jam up along the boards and hold it for a faceoff with 51 seconds remaining in the minor penalty to Cam Connor.
Here are the Aeros on the penalty killing situation, are number two in the World Hockey Association percentage-wise. Coming into the game, they had 58 goals scored against them in 288 attempts. And you have to keep in mind the number of penalties that the Aeros take. One of the most penalized teams in the World Hockey Association.
Here is Lacroix with Tinelli.
Who would be number one penalized team in the world?
Birmingham Bulls. Aeros playing their 66th game of the season tonight. Where is the season gone? Here's McLeod tying it up in that New England zone for a faceoff, and play is called as now Tinelli and McKenzie have something to say to one another.
I'll tell you, when the season goes quickly, it's usually because the team's playing well, Jerry, and the team has sort of slowly picked up momentum all season long and really starting to hit a stride, and I think still hasn't reached its full potential.
Here's Tinelli fighting McKenzie for the puck. The Aeros get it to Lacroix, who just dumps it out into center ice to take off more time of the penalty. Aeros shorthanded with Connor in the box, and now the Aeros clear it down the length of the ice. Going back is Mark Howe. Moving up to his own blue line and center ice for New England. Mark Howe moving into the Houston zone on right wing to McKenzie. A drive. Save made by Wakely. He covers up on top of the puck, and play is called. McKenzie shooting from a sharp angle. Really tested Ernie Wakely.
And sometimes if you can get enough steam on the puck, Mark Howe dumping that puck just off to McKenzie as he came across the blue line. McKenzie had a lot of speed, and that helped the weight of that puck as it hit the pads of Wakely. And if you hit just right in the crease, sometimes you get enough speed on it, it'll work its way through.
Face off to the left of Wakely here with 21 seconds left in Connor's penalty. From the draw, the Aeros get it to McLeod. He ties it up with Antonovich along the boards, and play is whistled down. They will face it off again in the circle to the left of 37-year-old Ernie Wakely, who has come up with another strong game in that Houston goal tonight.
See in the background some of the boys from Inwood Forest Country Club out in my neighborhood.
They're looking for you. Broke one of their windows.
The golf course where
from
Aeros are members.
From the faceoff of the right point, Plum in that Houston zone. Left point for Mark Howe. It's intercepted by Andre Lacroix. Here come the Aeros. They're a man short. Lacroix in center ice. Drops it now, then took a hit by Gordy Howe, and Gordy Howe winds up in a heap on the ice. Here's Tinelli breaking in across the line. Moves it back to center ice as Cam Connor steps back on. McLeod lead pass for Connor. In on right wing against Mark Howe. Connor in that New England zone stops to make a play. Centers it through for Tinelli. He runs into McKenzie, and here comes Plum. Plum has it poked away by Tinelli, but Gordy Howe carries on. Moving through center, Gordy Howe fakes a shot, moving in towards the Houston line, rolls back now as he had a teammate offside. Here's Gordy Howe in center ice, stopped by Tinelli, still with that puck, shooting it into the Houston zone. Wakely comes out to catch the puck about an inch off the ice and holds on for a faceoff.
I got a kick out of that one play Lacroix made just a few minutes ago. He's killing off the penalty, and he was just outside of that New England blue line. He had about four New England players converging on him. He waited to the last second. He put the puck between his legs and backed out of the play, and they almost all converged on each other. That was the old sandwich play, but there wasn't anything spread in the middle.
Here is Larry Hale. The Aeros leading 5-3 up on left wing for John Tinelli. Checked by Steve Carlson at the right point. It's held in by Brad Selwood. Dumps it in on the end boards in the Houston zone, and here's Cam Connor. Around on left wing for Tinelli, couldn't reach it. Going back for the Whalers is Selwood as it rolls back into his own zone. Selwood standing back of his own goal with the puck. His team down by two goals, now to Gordy Roberts in the near corner. Roberts, a rink-wide pass on right wing to Steve Carlson, moving through center ice. Now in on left wing for Danny Bolduc, in on goal, and it was offside anyway as Bolduc shoots it into the net after the whistle. And from the summit, this is Houston Aeros hockey. It will be family night Sunday night when the Aeros return home to take on the Indianapolis Racers here at the Summit. Here comes Larry Lund on left wing to Paul Pulpeil. Moving into the New England zone, a shot off the stick of Selwood up over the glass into the crowd as Selwood bumps with Pulpeil along the far boards. Play is called. A minute 11 left here in the first half of the third period. Aeros leading 5-3.
Jerry, later this month, the Aeros are going to be playing two international games, one against the Finnish national team. That'll be on the 19th, Sunday the 19th. And then on the 21st, and that is a schedule change. Originally scheduled for the 15th of March, the Swedish national team will be in on the 21st. So that'll be the Sunday and Tuesday evening. Tickets available, of course, at all seven Foleys and the Summit box office.
Faceoff coming up in that New England zone. You can also put the tickets on the Visa and MasterCard cards. Call 627-0916. That's 627-0916 to put your Aeros tickets on MasterCard or Visa.
I think a good idea.
Here's the puck taken by Marty Howe for the Whalers. Clearing it to center ice. John Hughes comes up with it for the Aeros. Now trying to get it to Ron Hanses. It's knocked away by the Whalers. And Rogers has it in center ice. Across the red line, shoots it into the Houston zone. It goes skittering off the inboards. And it comes to Marty Howe at the left point. A shot deflected by Rogers wide of the goal. And here comes Rich Preston for the Aeros. Less than a minute to play in the first half of the third period. The Aeros move in on right wing to Hanses in that New England zone. And it's called on the offside as Hanses was a hair offside on the right wing.
Andre Lacroix clapping his stick down on the ice there, thinking that he should have just made that pass a little bit quicker as Ron Hanse is moving in on that right wing in anticipation of the pass. Lacroix likes to hold the puck until the defenseman comes to him so that he completely takes him out of the play, Jerry, and that's why a lot of times he'll give his wingers clear-cut breakaways.
Al McLeod for the Aeros in the center ice zone to Rich Preston. Now to Andre Lacroix. Here's Lacroix circling with that puck. Got around Mike Rogers down right wing. Lacroix chased back by Marty Howell. Lacroix still with it for the Aeros. On right wing to Ron Hanses. Hanses got it now to John Hughes, clearing it into the Whaler zone off the end boards. Coming back to get it, Rick Lee. 20 seconds left in the first half of the third period. Left wing pass to Marty Howell. Down that left wing and center ice across the red line, moving into the Houston zone. Lost it to Hanses. It was offside anyway, with Larry Plow in ahead of the play on left wing. We have 10:15 left in regulation time. The Aeros in front, 5-3.
Smith, you know, has shut the Aeros out a couple of times this season. Both times have been here in Houston. He's the second leading goaltender in the league in the goals against department. Only Gary Bromley is ahead of him. And he leads the league in games played with 48.
Aeros losing that puck in center ice, cleared back in by the Whalers. John Hughes goes back for the Aeros. Jack Carlson after him. They clear it on left wing for Rich Preston. 3 seconds to go until the buzzer here. Now Hanses in center ice, lost it to Marty Howe at the buzzer. The first half of the third period ends with the Aeros leading 5-3.
Jerry, Teddy Taylor skating a little bit better there, and he should be back into action. You heard Scott Campbell in at the first period break there, and he feels that he'll be ready for action on Sunday, so you like to get everybody healthy again, along with the three goaltenders, Zimmerman and Rutledge and Wakely. I think the Aeros are heading down the stretch in pretty good shape. They get Terebinski back, gives him a little more depth on that blue line, a little more mobility also, because he's not all that big, Terebinski, but he can handle the puck well, and he can give you some more versatility on your hockey club.
All right, Bill Friday, the referee, ready to drop it between Terry Ruskowski and Dave Keon for the final 10 minutes of regulation time. The Aeros in front, 5-3. Here's Ruskowski on the draw against Keon, and from the faceoff it comes to Mike Antonovich in his own zone on right wing to Brad Selwood. Selwood, a left wing pass to Gordy Roberts. Roberts through center ice, flips it down into the Houston zone, knocked down by Paul Pulpeil, who clears it to center ice. Keon takes over, shoots it right back into the Houston zone. Here's Lukowich on the end boards for the Aeros. Left wing pass to John Gray. Gray for Houston. Down left wing in center ice with Ruskowski. Here's a pass to Lukowich on right wing, moving in around Mike Antonovich. Lukowich looking for the hat trick. In on the end boards, bumped by Gordy Roberts. Now here's Pulpeil holding it in to Lukowich. He tries to make a play. Lukowich fighting for that puck. It's taken now by Selwood as Selwood and Lukowich do some fencing. It's cleared to center ice. Now Selwood checked by John Gray, and Selwood steps into him. Now Ruskowski nails Mayer with a hard check along the boards. It's cleared to center, shot back in with Ruskowski trapped in there. Offside at the New England blue line, and from the Summit, This is Houston Aeros hockey.
Two minutes for interference. Okay, boys.
While we were away, Jim Mayer of the New England Whalers takes an interference penalty at 10:54 of this third period. And the Aeros, who lead 5-3, go to the power play.
John Gray drawing that penalty. And the thing about Gray is he has good anticipation, can break into those holes. And a lot of times he'll catch the winger that's checking him off balance. And I think that's what probably happened, and Mayer panicked. Grabbed a hold of him because he knew he was beaten on the inside.
Lukowich over at the Aeros bench to get a new hockey stick.
Morris Lukowich, one of two hockey players on this Aero squad who have had hat tricks this season already. He has two goals here tonight, looking for his third. The other gentleman who has also had a couple of hat tricks over the season, John Gray, out there on the left wing.
Face off to the right of Smith. That comes to Popiel at the left point along the near boards for John Gray. He missed it. Selwood and Gray go to the corner. Comes to Gordy Roberts. He tried to clear it out. Andre Lacroix missed it. Terry Ruskowski holding it in. Now Mike Antonovich steals it. Shoots it down the ice on goal. Ernie Wakely makes the save. Clears it on left wing to Paul Popiel. Cutting back of his own goal. A minute 40 left in the New England penalty. Popiel headmans the puck to Andre Lacroix down left wing in center ice. Lacroix in on left wing to John Gray. Moving in against Selwood. Deep looking to center to hit the side of the goal. Now going in. Lacroix against Dave Keon. It's tied up. Now, Lukowich goes to the corner, takes a run at Gordy Roberts. Some pushing and shoving down in that corner, and the linesmen get in there very quickly to separate Lukowich from Gordy Roberts. We haven't seen Rick Lee in a while for New England.
I tell you, you better watch that puck when it comes around the boards the next time. I think Lukowich moved that board that he hit back about 6 inches. He actually missed Roberts. Roberts was only insulted. He wasn't hurt. 7,995, 8,000 here tonight, Jerry. We were hoping to get it over the 10,000 mark, but
on the faceoff, the Aeros get the draw to Gray on the near boards, and then New England zone centers it. Here's Lukowich, a shot, and he fired it wide, going for the hat trick. And the rebound rolls all the way down the ice into the Houston zone, and here's Paul Popiel. Up with the blue line for Andre Lacroix, moving through center ice. Lacroix, lead pass for Gray, in with Lukowich. Here's a pass back at the point, intercepted by Keon. He failed to clear it as Lacroix held it in. It's taken now by Selwood down right wing, moving through center, flips it into the Houston zone. Going back is Captain Terry Ruskowski. 53 seconds left in the Whalers penalty as Ruskowski moves through center ice. Ruskowski still with that puck. Walking in now to Lukowich, in on goal, and he lost the puck. And here comes Mike Rogers for New England. Across the red line in center ice. Rogers in with a slap shot. Going to his knees, Wakely makes the save. A good one. Here is Andre Lacroix for the Aeros with 33 seconds left in the penalty. Andre Lacroix moving up to center ice. Across the red line. Fires it into the Whalers zone. Racing in Lukowich on his backhand. Couldn't get a shot. Now here's Tonelli after it. It's taken away by Plum. He tried to clear it. Popiel holding it in. Now to John Tonelli. Rolling it to Ruskowski. Fans on the shot. Puck is picked up by Plum, and here come the Whalers. Ron Plum down left wing. John Tonelli breaks it up. Here's Ruskowski. Now to Lacroix. Lead pass to Lukowich on left wing. Racing in after it. Shooting off the target. And Lukowich was bumped by Rick Lee. Aeros get it to John Tonelli. The Whalers break it up as Tonelli is tripped up by Plum. Penalized player Mayer is back on. Here is Tonelli for the Aeros. Into Cam Connor. To Andre Lacroix. Stomping now to make a play at the right point for John Hughes. A shot. Blocked in front. Rebound. Tonelli. A shot. Save. Rebound. Connor scores. Connor makes it 6-3 for the Aeros. Hughes and Tonelli will get the assist as the Aeros move in front by three.
Well, that does it. And well deserved.
He's hit the post three times tonight.
You know, you make the good play and you, and you fire it hard, you fire it right in the right spot, it just hits the post, and then Connor just kind of nonchalantly standing there, getting that rebound, having it open it. Net on the left side, but he didn't even mind a little shot after the goal, just taking it casually.
Connor is 21st of the year. Heroes lead it 6-3. Here's Gordy Roberts in his own zone. A left wing to Marty Howe trying to clear it in center ice. He lost it to Cam Cutter, now to John Hughes. Hughes lost it to McKenzie, who clears it into the Houston zone. Larry Hale breaks it up, now to Larry Lund. Gave it away to Mark Howe, racing in on goal, and the goaltender Wakely comes out to corral the puck and hold on for a faceoff.
6:31 remaining, and the Aeros have really, I think, put the Whalers in the third period back on their heels some, as they've continued to put the pressure on, and that's been the difference. When they've stopped skating here tonight, the Whalers have been somewhat of a threat, but if the Aeros really wanted to, they seem to have been able to take charge in the hockey game.
Faceoff will be to the right of Ernie Wakely. Larry Lund on the draw against Gordy Howe, and from the faceoff, Gordy got it to Marty Howe, a shot that goes wide. Now Tinelli on left wing, winding up with it in his own zone. Big John Tinelli to John Hughes, clearing it out into center ice, and here's Mark Howe with Connor after him. They get it to McKenzie, flipping it into the Houston zone. It's offside as McKenzie waited a little too long, and Marty Howe was in ahead of the puck at that Houston blue line.
Well, Saturday morning at 11 o'clock on KHTV, channel 39, Aeros Hockey Highlights. Won't you join us? Special guest this Saturday morning will be Al McLeod, a gentleman that is really been a big contributor back on that blue line core for the Aeros.
It's going to be tough tonight, whoever selects the three stars in this hockey game. John Hughes bumped by Mark Howe. The puck cleared to McKenzie, broken up by the Aeros' Larry Hale. He shoots it down the ice for Larry Lund, who took it over the center ice red line. Offside at center ice red line, and it was originating inside the Houston blue line. It was completed over the Whalers' half of center ice.
Jerry, I think that's a good sign when you, just exactly what you said, it's tough to pick a star because the whole team has been a star, and that's the way it's been lately for the Aeros. It's been an effort that you've had from everyone, and that's a good sign of a good hockey club.
Gordy Roberts clears it into the Houston zone. Wakely, out of his goal, sets it up for John Hughes. The Aeros leading 6-3. Now, Connor tried to clear it out down the ice. He does, and Gordy Roberts goes back to get it. Here's Roberts, chased around his own goal by Larry Lund. Tinelli is after Roberts. Now it comes to Gordy Howe, who tried to clear it. John Tinelli takes it away in center ice, back in that Houston zone. Here's Tinelli on right wing to John Hughes. In center ice to Larry Lund, looking for some help. Drops it back to John Hughes. Long lead pass on left wing to Cam Connor. Back now to Larry Hale. Hale for the Aeros. In on right wing for Larry Lund in that New England zone. A pass to Tinelli. In on goal. He lost the puck. Now here come the Whalers back. Marty Howe down left wing with Gordy Howe and Johnny McKenzie. McKenzie in on right wing, and it's offside at that Houston blue line. McKenzie tried to complete a play, but was whistled on the offside anyway.
Gordy did a double shuffle at the blue line trying to confuse the officials. He didn't know whether he kept his leg back there enough or not to keep him onside. He's doing a little counting here. And
a little signaling to Rusty Stonefeld as to who we would like to have on our postgame show. 5:20 remaining here in the third period. The Aeros leading 6-3. New England better do something in a hurry if they're going to have a chance in this game. And you don't think the Aeros love this tonight, winning by three and a chance to move into second place, a tie for second? Now the puck is cleared into the Houston zone, and here comes John Shella, tripped up. Crowd wanted a penalty, and referee Bill Friday says no. Crowd here hungry tonight for the Aeros to pour it on the Whalers. Now the Whalers dump it back into the Houston zone. Steve Carlson steals it, a shot wide of the target. Lukowich for the Aeros trying to clear it. Hengsleben holding it in. Here's John Shella for the Aeros to John Gray. Moving out on right wing and center ice to Terry Ruskowski. Ruskowski now to Gray. In on left wing across that Whalers line. Lost it to Steve Carlson. He has it for the Whalers. Winding up in his own zone. Checked by Morris. Lukowich got by him. Steve Carlson, who was in that movie Slapshot, moving into the Houston zone. Knocked down by Al McLeod. Here's Terry Ruskowski just standing still. Two men get by him. Clears it to center ice. Rick Lee breaks it up. He's checked Ruskowski after the puck. The Whalers hit it with a high stick, and one of their teammates pick it up. Play is whistled to a halt.
What is happening next Monday evening?
Aeros Booster Club will sponsor their annual appreciation banquet. Dunphy's Royal Coach Inn on the Southwest Freeway, Bel Air exit.
And they say a majority of the tickets have gone already, but still some remaining. So if you come to the Aeros game on Sunday, you can sign up at the Aeros Booster Club booth.
Here is McLeod for the Aeros inside his own blue line. 4:20 left here in the third period. The Aeros leading 6-3. Selwood now takes the puck away, shoots it into the Houston zone, and here's Morris Lukowich on the end boards to John Shella. Sherlock, right wing pass to Terry Ruskowski, now to Morris Lukowicz, losing it to Tim Sheehy. Sheehy in center ice, got it to Steve Carl sitting on right wing to Hangsleben. Hangsleben drops it on the end boards in the Houston zone, and here's Shella winding up on right wing. Now to Terry Ruskowski, and the Aeros break out. Ruskowski moving through center, in across the New England line, spinning around Selwood, in a shot, and he misses on the short side. Rebound comes to McLeod. He tried to center it. Play is called, and there's going to be a penalty here to Terry Ruskowski. He got involved with Brad Selwood down in the far corner, so New England goes to the power play. And from the summit, this is Houston Aeros hockey.
And a bench minor to New England.
Well, Ruskowski got a minor for high sticking at 16-11, and then the Whalers bench got a minor penalty. I don't know what that was about.
Now that's a little bit of irony, I'll tell you. The other team gets a penalty, and then you get a bench minor. I don't know whether you'd be complaining about that one too much, unless you wanted more than two, but I'd take whatever I could get and keep my mouth shut, wouldn't you?
One would think so. Maybe that's why the Whalers have fallen from first place.
Well, they're frustrated. Eight out of the last 10 they've lost. Maybe nine out of the last 11. That's
Aeros. Aeros have Steve West and Don Laraway out there now. Houston leading 6-3. Here's Shella stealing it in center ice. Shella, as West ran over Antonovich in center ice. Here's McLeod into Steve West on right wing in that New England zone, centering it. Nobody home. Going in after Laraway against Ron Plum, and Plum plays it around on left wing for Mike Antonovich. He gave it away to Don Laraway. Laraway moving in front, couldn't get a shot. Laraway at the left point for Al McLeod, poking it to the corner for Laraway. In against Plum, it comes around on the far boards for Mike Antonovich. And back come the New England Whalers. Antonovich hooked off the puck by Steve West, who's going to get a penalty here. Play is called a hooking penalty against Steve West. And now the New England Whalers, unless they take another bench minor, will get the extra man.
Come on, Harry.
I don't blame it on Harry Neal, the New England coach. Yeah, could have been one of the players or the trainer.
Maybe we can get Bill Friday to skate a little closer to the New England bench. We can even it up. 3:06 remaining. The Aeros ahead by 3. It's a 6-3 hockey game that the Aeros, for the most part, have dominated, really. Although there have been spots in the game where you... But New England just doesn't have a consistent flow out there, Jerry. They seem to be going in spurts, and they do not have that sort of united front that they had earlier. They're missing players like Lyle and, as you mentioned, Webster. I think Big Lyle is a factor for them. Hurts an awful lot.
So West goes off for hooking at 16:54, and the Aeros, who lead by 3, are now 2 men short. New England is 1 man short. The Aeros clear it down the length of the ice. John Tinelli is blown forward with Hale and Hughes on defense. The Whalers have out. Gordie Howe up front with Rogers. Roberts and Mark Howe on the points. Here's a pass in on left wing for Mike Rogers. In a shot, Wakely to save. Rebound cleared away by Hughes down the ice. John Hughes has played an outstanding game back on that Aeros defense tonight.
Maybe one of the last times you see Gordie Howe
here in the summit. We'll be seeing him up in New England at least one more time. Now the Whalers. Twice more, as a matter of fact. The Whalers in that Houston zone at the left point. Roberts in for Mark Howe. A shot hit Gordie Howe and bounced wide. Rogers on the far boards. Clears it back at the left point for Gordie Roberts. It was off the target. And the puck rolls to center ice. Here's Larry Hale clearing it down into the Houston zone. Down into the New England zone. And Roberts goes back to get it. Now here come the Whalers. Gordie Roberts flips it down into the Houston end, going in after it. Mark Howe, Ernie Wakely steers it away from him. Now, Roberts centers it. Mark Howe, a shot, he scores! Mark Howe on the power play. And what did Jack Stanfield just written down? Thanks a lot, Jack.
I said Mark Howe is not shooting. I wrote it down, a little message, and then Mark Howe took my word for it and decided to fire one. But he hasn't really been shooting as much as you normally see Mark, who has one of the better shots in hockey, really. With that wrist shot, though, on that last one, closing the score to 6-4, but With a minute and 53 left, they're going to go back to even strength. Johnny McKenzie saying a few words to the fans here, and he doesn't only upset the hockey players, but he upsets the fans as well. We're going to listen to Jerry at the end of this hockey game, as maybe we'll get another chance to play our little champions feature, and I think this one's going to feel real, real fine.
I think they gave the assist there. We'll have to check to see if they gave it to Gordie Howe. Now here's McKenzie in deep in that Houston zone, trying to make a play, bumps with Paul Popiel. Here's Marty Howe in a shot. Wakely the save, rebound, centered in front. A shot by Hangsley, but just missed. Here's Paul Popiel, checked by Keon. The Whalers all over the Aeros, plumb from the point, a drive. What a save by Wakely. McKenzie, bumped by Shella in front. Now at the right point, Plum holding it in. Aeros break it up, Ruskowski clears it out for Rich Preston. Here come the Aeros, now to Terry Ruskowski. It's taken away by the Whalers, Ruskowski steals it. Terry moving in on right wing against Marty Howe. Shooting, Smith the save, juggles it, the rebound cleared away. Now Preston steps into Keon, Ruskowski in that corner with Marty Howe as well, and play is called.
Well, the Aeros, even though they took control coming out there, it's still a little bit sloppy because you never want to let them get within that one goal shot because they're going to pull the goaltender, or you might even see them pull the goaltender behind by two, Jerry. 1:13. They will not pull the goaltender right now because they're down deep in that New England territory, but Al Smith will be getting his orders, and he's looking toward that New England bench.
That last New England scoring play, Mark Howe from Roberts at 18:07, and not Gordie Howe. That cuts the Aeros lead to 6-4. We have a minute 13 left in the game. Face off to the left of Al Smith. You're listening to Aeros Hockey on KTRH in Houston, the sports voice of the Southwest.
Mark Howe has only 18 goals in the season.
Face off will be to the left of Al Smith. Now Rogers is kicked out of the faceoff. Antonovich will take the draw against Andre Lacroix. Now they finally get everybody lined up, and from the draw, the Aeros lose the faceoff. Here comes Mike Rogers down right wing, stopping at his own blue line, moves to center ice, lead pass on left wing for Antonovich, too far. Wakely lets it roll into his own zone, going back to touch it, Rich Preston, and the New England Whalers are called for icing. Gordie Howe, perhaps in his final shift ever here in the Summit, although the Aeros will face them twice in New England during the remainder of this season. Gordie Howe, and perhaps his farewell shift in the magnificent Summit. Had some good times here, hasn't he?
Well, certainly scoring that 900th goal was 900th regular season goal, Jerry, was quite an accomplishment. Of course, he's got over 1,000 all told in his career.
Now, some fan yells out Gordie Who, and the crowd gets a charge out of that. Here's Lacroix for the Aeros, now to Rich Preston, as Lacroix took a slash at Gordie Howe. Gordie Howe and Lacroix bring their sticks up. Loose puck in that New England zone. Battle for. Gordie Howe and Lacroix fencing in front. Play goes right on. Now, here's Lacroix tripped up by Gordie Howe, and back come the New England Whalers. On left wing, it's Mike Antonovich clearing it into the Houston zone. Wakely the stop. 30 seconds to go, and play is called here. New England had too many men on the ice, I believe. Or was it offside? Too many men on the ice, is it?
Well,
Friday talking it over with Larry Plo.
Face off at center, the man probably jumped on, the goalie was coming over, jumped on a little bit too early.
Quick. That's the correct call. Now, in one of the games on this last road trip for the Aeros, that happened in Quebec, and they gave the Aeros a penalty, which was the wrong call. Here comes the chant of goodbye, Whalers. Now face off in center ice, Lacroix against Rogers, and the Aeros get the draw. Lacroix shooting it down the ice into the New England zone with 23 seconds to go. Here comes Gordie Roberts on right wing to Mark Howe for the Whalers. Through center, lead pass for Rogers, too far. Going back is Hanses for the Aeros. He gets the puck. Now the goaltender Smith heads for the bench. The Whalers have out six attackers. Puck is held in the near corner along the boards by three Whalers players, along with Rich Preston of the Aeros. Face off coming up to the left of Wakely. 11 seconds to go in the game. The Aeros leading 6-4. The Aeros 11 seconds away from moving into a tie for second place in the World Hockey Association standings.
Listen to the Aeros Saturday night in Indianapolis as they attempt to move ahead of New England, hoping that they're watching New England, of course, tomorrow night in Birmingham. And then Sunday night back in the Summit against
Indianapolis at 6 o'clock. So come on out and support the Aeros. They're playing great, great hockey. I know you'll enjoy it. Bring the whole family. 6 o'clock, special family prices, the 550 seats for the $3.
Larry Lund will take the faceoff against Gordie Howe to the left of Ernie Wakely. The Whalers with a ganging attack here have out six attackers. Their goal is empty. Aeros leading 6-4. Now faceoff. The faceoff will be to the left of Ernie Wakely, and Lund is going to be kicked out of the faceoff. John Tadelli will take the draw against Gordie Howe. From the faceoff, the Aeros get it. Lund trying to clear it, held in by the Whalers. Now it's loose in front. Shella breaks it up for the Aeros, clears it to the corner, but not out. 3 seconds left. Shella ties it up. Puck is held, and now the buzzer goes to end the game. And the Houston Aeros defeat the New England Whalers 6-4 to defeat the Whalers and move into a tie for second place in the World Hockey Association standings. And the Aeros come out and mob one another as the Aeros have moved into a tie with the Whalers for second place in the World Hockey Association as they defeat the Whalers 6-4 tonight before 7,995 here in the Summit. Final score once again, the Aeros 6 and the Whalers 4 from the Summit. This is Houston Aeros Hockey.
Rusty?
Hello there. Hello there. Hello, Trooper. Troop.
Yeah, just a second, Rusty.
The record 34-28, the tie for second place in the WHA. And with that goal, on Sunday night,
what were the shots in the third?